Good evening and welcome to episode 13 of the Sofferone Saga. My name is Dave Gibson and I'm the Dungeon Master. First up, we have a few announcements to get through before we start tonight's adventure. Did someone say 200 plus new beasts to be used as party pets, character companions, familiars, encounters, polymorph options, and of course, wild shape shenanigans? What about 12 beast-flavored subclasses or 20 new beastly magic items? Well, get this and more in Bergen's Book of Beasts. The Kickstarter is live, and just for our viewers tonight, we've decided to extend by 1 hour the deadline for receiving a free copy of Firestar Falling. That's right, if you back a physical tier in the next hour, you'll get it. You will receive a free copy, free hardback copy of the adventure Firestar Falling. This will be the last time this adventure is up for grabs for free, so get on it and back the Kickstarter now. You'll see the link pop up in the chat over the course of the stream. You can also buy merch for the Sofferone Saga and all of the other streams on Penny Dragon's merch store right now. Just click the link in the chat when it pops up and it will direct you right there. You can also click on the merch section on Penny Dragon's Twitch when we're not streaming and find your way to the store that way. All of the VODs for the Sofferone Saga are available on the Penny Dragon YouTube, and you'll find the other streams there too, neatly sorted into playlists. So give us a like and a sub and help us to grow our channel. Some great news coming up at the moment. We have LoreCon Dublin 2022, which is a new convention, which is going to be on its first year. You can join us for an epic day of TTRPGs. When is it? It's on Saturday, April the 16th from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Where is it? It's in Underworld Gaming, which is 9 and 10 Belgarde Square West in Tallaght. And what is it? It's a day of geeking out and gaming. You get an official LoreCon lanyard, a gift bag of holding, 4 to 6 hour game with an experienced GM, so that's not me, LoreCon character sheet, one entry into the LoreCon loot crate draw, which the loot crate is worth over 500 euro, apparently, and more. There's two tickets, one for 15 and one for 20, so I assume the 20 euro one gives you a lot more.
The 20 euro ticket gives you a free mag of holding, I think.
There you go,
free mag of holding. Which excellent is, I think, stuff. Usually about 25 euro on sale. So, $25.
So, yeah, so it's worth it. So check that out and have a look. There's only 100 tickets available. Beginners and experienced gamers are welcome, and game registration begins at 10:30 a.m. You must be over 16 years old to get on the ride. Now, look ahead at what's coming up in the other Penny Dragon streams. There's no Violet Madness this week, but instead we have Sunday Fight Night. In the blue corner, we have a group of level 20 adventurers. In the red corner, we have a very hungry and a very angry Tarrasque. That's on Sunday at 7 p.m. GMT, and we've roped in some extra players in the vain hope that it will make a difference. It probably won't. I'm reliably informed that Mark has made some modifications to this Tarrasque, so make sure to tune in for that. Mark GMs the Tuesday game that myself and Shane have been playing in for quite some time, and we call these things Corrigan Creations. They're always bad news. Fellowship of the Fallen is back on Tuesday. The party made their way to Axholm and tried to force their way inside, alerting the undead to their presence. But is that all that lurks in those abandoned halls? Clearing it out might take some time. You can catch the Churn Gang's last session on YouTube this week. Next week on March 25th, find out what happens to the gang as they try to escape hundreds of gnolls in the deadlands of Yinogu. The Cloaks of Minehelm return on Sunday, March 27th at 7 p.m. GMT. Having raised suspicions and croaking alarm of the Bullywood clan, party are ankle deep in trouble. But in the fetid den of these amphibious foes, an unexpected ally awaits them. That's Ben trying to catch me out a very hard-to-read promo there, but I got him. Big thanks to our man at the Tech Bunker, Christian, who looks after all things Twitch streaming and, of course, keeping the goblins out of our chat. Couldn't do this without him. We'd like to thank as well Kate from It's a Map for creating all of the amazing maps you see right here in the Sofferone Saga. You can find Kate on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook on @itsamapIore. All the music you hear in the stream is from Tabletop Audio. You can go over to the website to find out more about what they do. And if you're running your own Roll20 Adventures, they're right up there in the jukebox. You know you can influence the game from chat. I think all of our chat friends know that at this stage. I'm not going to go through exactly what does what. You can scroll down on the About section of the Twitch and you'll see it there. With that out of the way, let's meet our players. Let's start with Shane tonight.
Yeah, so my name is Shane. I'm playing Jaden, a human battle master fighter who's running around with his trusty glaive. And he has been, I suppose, taking the night of the long rest to, I suppose, work through his forms and study his own technique.
Any montage. I like it. Joe?
Robert's probably joining him for those. I'm typing Knight of the Long Robert. I'm playing a Robert. I'm a human rogue. I am not like your stereotypical rogue, and I write stuff, and I'm weird.
Indeed he is, but we love him.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Fona, you're up next.
So hi, I play Scales, who is a young dragonborn barbarian trying out this life on the road, adventuring, saving things. And so far it's going, you know, top aces. So
excellent. Next up is Carrig.
Hi, I'm Carrig. I play Ren, the human transmutation wizard, who has, similar to Jade and Robert, have kind of spent the night practicing things. He's developed a few more powerful techniques and spells in the last 8 or so hours. Stuck the rest about, he took sleep too, but in the last hour or so, sitting in the airship before he went to sleep.
Okay. Excellent. Jonathan, you're up.
Hi, everybody. I play Fenar, a wood elf monk that's having bad dreams and hopefully
sure is.
Figure out what's going on with his dreams.
Okay. Last but not least, Jean.
Present everyone. I play Lamut. He is the half orc druid, Circle of the Moon. Unlike Fenar, he slept like a baby because he was effed up in the last fight beyond recognition, basically, because someone decided to open a door without checking for traps.
Yes, it did. Okay. Thanks,
gang. I checked for traps, but okay.
Time for a recap.
It was ruined. There's a difference.
Time for a recap, guys. Thanks. Our heroes have finally rescued the kidnapped gnome Gribble from the clutches of the bandit leader Stiletto and the wizard Asher. With Stiletto in the wind and Asher lying dead at their feet, the party decided to rest for the night. All slept well, except for Fenar, who had a second encounter in his dream with an old pupil from his monastery, Soak, which we'll get to in a moment. It turns out Gribble's wife, the apothecary Grelda, might have had something to do with his abduction, but they'll have to make it back to town to find out for sure. Has the carved witch driven any more children insane in the interim? What is the royal agent Valder doing poking around a town as remote as this? Only one way to find out. Let's play some D&D. So, for those of you that weren't here at the end of the last session, I'm going to run through very quickly Fenar's second dream. So, and we'll see what happens there, because he's a choice to make. So, Fenar, as you reach that center of yourself, that meditative state that recharges and refreshes your soul, your ki, and your physical body, you find yourself back at your old monastery, Soak. Standing at the gates, a crisp breeze blows past you, and the leaves and the trees surrounding the clearing rustle under it, almost sounding like 1,000 hushed whispers. You walk towards the monastery gates and see no guards at post. Looking up at the high walls, you see none of your brothers and sisters walking their routes. Very strange. Treading as silently as possible, past the wooden huts in the outskirts, you make your way towards the center of the community, the Alem Shar, the Master's Dojo. As you near this sacred place, usually filled with the noises of battle and focused training, the only sound you hear is that of the boughs of the trees creaking under the light winds. No sounds of fist on wood, no battle cries, just silence. It's then that you notice the thin wooden doors to the Alem Shar Est, the Master's fighting pit in the middle of the Alem Shar, lying in ruins. Through the shattered portal, you see the fighting pit itself, the sands always perfectly raked and calm when not in use, now a scene of blood and chaos. At the other side of the fighting pit, at the base of the wooden steps, you see your old master, Abelis, lying still in the sand, his body twisted and ruined, with a familiar figure standing over him with his back to you. Welcome, brother. I got what I needed from him. I now know where the next source is. You will do well to let me pass and step aside. As he walks towards you around the tree, he places his hand on the trunk, and you see the ancient bark turn black and the leaves wither and fall from the now decaying branches. Rounding the tree now, he approaches you, each footstep perfectly measured, landing toe first and then heel, exactly as you were both taught. His fists clenched by his side are wrapped in a tight black corded set of fingerless gloves that seem to glow with a dull purple light. A thin longsword hangs on his back while a vicious-looking whip is coiled at his belt. Over one shoulder is slung what looks like a long scroll case, but its contents are a mystery to you at present. His shaved head has grown out slightly, and you see for the first time the beginnings of a black head of hair. His eyes, though, have changed utterly. Gone are the piercing green eyes that never betrayed emotion or intent in the sparring match. Replaced now by pools of pure black, reminding you of the corrupted lake in your first dream. All they convey now are hatred. Let me pass, and I let you live. The air turns crisper now, and large flakes of snow begin to fall, drifting lazily through the air and settling on the bloodied sand, almost forming a veil of purity over the chaotic and evil deeds that have taken place here today. It occurs to you now that nature will always erase the deeds and misdeeds of humanoids, given enough time. But as Gorwin inches towards you, you snap out of your musings and slip into a fighting stance, realizing time is the one thing you do not have at this moment. Gorwin's head cocks bemusedly as you consider his offer, and he takes another step forward. His wraps flare with dark energy as he clenches and unclenches his fists, a smile creeping across his face. Well, what's it to be, outcast? You look to your old master, wheezing what looked like his final breaths, and then to Gorwin, a crooked smile on his face as he raises an eyebrow questioningly. It's clear you have a choice to make. As Gorwin said, what's it to be?
Well, Nora's just going to look at Gorwin. It's like, what happened? As I walk, like, just past him, I don't even look at Gorwin. I just look at Abelus lying there.
Okay. So, you step aside and let him pass.
Basically, but yeah, like, I ask him, Gorwin, what happened to you? What happened here? As I walk.
He takes one look, and as you both pass, a respectful distance between each of you, your heads turn as you walk past each other, both of you on your utmost guard. And he just does a... Still the teacher's bet, it seems. Continue to use your key the way you've been using it. It helps me find you on the physical world, my friend. And he leaves the Alim Shar. You run to your master, who's lying one shoulder up on the stairs, one on the bloodied sand, his cough of blood. Villar. He reaches his hand up.
I just like also reach my hand towards him as I run towards him now quicker.
Okay. He says, he coughs up more blood and says, he can't kill me here. He can't kill me here. He can't kill you either. But he's looking for you. He's looking for you. The physical world. He slips back. His eyes go glassy. He's still breathing shallowly. Do you want to do anything?
Did you say why he's looking for me? What's the source?
Roll inside check.
Seven.
Really hard to tell. He's coming in and out of consciousness. And even with a seven, you can see and you understand that the question you've asked him is something. You can see he would rather die than answer. Even with that seven, you can see there's no way he's answering that question.
And there's
his bloodied hand touches your cheek, and you can see, or you can feel, your master's blood running down your cheek now. And he says, "Use your key sparingly, lest he find you." And then he sinks back.
As that happens, I turn around to see if I can see Gorwin still.
He is gone. And with that, you awake in the airship, which is nice and warm and very, very comfortable. Let me just move you over. There we go. You feel like you haven't slept for maybe, like you've slept for maybe an hour, hour and a half. So you guys are wherever you like to be in the airship. I know Scales is in bed. You guys were over on the right-hand side. Was anyone keeping watch? I think you all agree that you felt rather safe, didn't you?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Excellent.
Ren is like twitching in the corner as if he's drank way too much coffee and he's testing the new spell.
Cool, cool, cool. So you wake up, Fenar. What would you like to do? Would you like to go back to sleep straight away? Would you like to get up and walk around, clear your head? What's happening with Fenar?
Fenar is just like, when he wakes up, he's out of breath because it's like he got some really big news and stuff. So he's just going to walk outside to grab some air.
Okay, cool. Where are you walking? Where are you and where are you walking?
I'm just like straight out, just bit outside the wall, our door.
Okay, cool, cool, cool. Jaden has a blast there, so you can rack that up. Thanks, Tyrion Shadowbane.
Thanks, R2-D2, for the follow.
Okay, so it's pitch black. There are some sort of dancing firefly kind of magical lights that just flicker around this top layer. It's hard to tell if they're sort of a magical asset placed there by Gribble or if they're somehow alive, but they never seem to flit further than, you know, the side of the walls here. And now that you sort of study them, you can see that they tend to keep maybe 10 or 15 feet ahead of where you are. And there's usually more than one. The result being that you can pretty much see wherever you want to in kind of normal light here as if it were, you know, dim light. But I know Fenar can, he has night vision as well.
Yeah.
But for the rest of you, if you were up after a bad dream, that's what you would see. What would you like to do, Fenar?
He's just going to sit now there and just question himself, trying to figure out what source and what Abilis stole them.
I'm only joking. okay, cool. Grant, so you're sitting there for the next while. You let me know if you're gonna. You only need 4 hours, so you've plenty of time to go back and get some more sleep. If no one has anything else to do during this long rest, I'm happy to say you guys got your long rest, and we are back the next morning. Unless Fenar wants to wake someone up, ruin their long rest, and say, "Hey, I had a bad dream."
No, you just keep quiet.
Okay, cool. Okay, it's the next morning, and you are awoken by your friend Gribble. Very, very loudly, his voice seems to resonate magically through this whole area and into the other one. Well, lads, isn't it great now? We're all alive. We're all fucking raring to go. How he is now this morning, lads? What's the fucking story?
Morning. I'm feeling
he rubs up and starts bouncing great. In the bed here beside Scales. Well, Dragonborn, I ain't fucking seen one of ye. Jesus, I don't think ever. What's the story with you? Wake up! Wake up! And he starts shoving Scales.
No, no. And Scales is going to somewhat unintentionally whack out an arm to push the annoying feature away.
Okay, roll a d20, Scales. Two.
Oh, okay, two.
Yeah, he's bouncing on the bed and you just kind of take a swing for him when he's at the top of the bounce. He lands, he goes,
under.
Oh no, wake up, lads, wake up, wake up. I haven't got the makings of breakfast here at all. I'm fucking starving now. Will we go back to town? It might take a while, but go back to town. I'd love a fry up. I'd love a dirty big fry.
Would you what like a piggyback to town?
Hey, or a gnome back? I got that joke. I'm talking about a fry and you said a piggyback. I like you. I fucking like you.
Scales will kind of go, what?
Very good, very good, very good. Well, I believe we came to an agreement, didn't we? You lads can keep everything you found here. I'm not paying as a jot. And that's it. That was a deal, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yep. Very good, very good.
I mean... No, wait, weren't you going to, like, give us money, too?
No, he gave us potions.
No, sure wasn't it me wife, the dirty, cheating bitch. who offered a reward for you, or for me. So you can take it up with her. I believe I've given you 2 potions of arcane recovery and you have 2 potions of greater healing. Isn't that right?
We're getting a better deal. A potion of greater healing, like, doesn't that retail for like 500 gold pieces?
Of course they do. There's not much call for them around here at all now, I tell you. Those lads down in the Hunter's Guild, they say they go out into the forest and all that shite. But they're never coming buying potions of healing. They mustn't go further than a day's travel.
Hunter's Guild, another thing to do instead of the main quest. The
Hunter's Guild. That's them. Right, so what's the crack? Are you ready to go? It's a 2-day journey back to town. What do you reckon? What do you want to do here?
Gail's is going to stand up and do his like morning stretches and his neck around, and you'll hear click, click, clack, and then he'll like be like, yep, yeah, okay, ready.
Okay.
Pick up his stuff.
Cool. Yeah. And just to let all of chat know, your heroes leveled up last session, after taking out Asher and forcing Stiletto to go on the run. So everyone is now level 5. Which means it is going to get big now. It's going to be fireballs and all sorts of crap.
Not yet.
So,
not for me.
Well, we'll see. Well, maybe at you.
At you, but not at me, maybe. Not from me. Not yet.
Okay, cool. Jaden, anyone else want to do anything before we leave?
Yeah, can I do 2 things?
Yeah.
One, I know there was... carpets checked at the last session, but I just want to check, was this underneath the ones that are in this room, or was that in the previous room?
I'll move your character down to the previous room and you should be able to see it was down in this room.
I suppose I just having seen there. That be successful in the last in here, one of the last things we do before we go is just, I suppose, kick the ones here, see if there's anything underneath
in the bedroom.
Should we
wait for Gribble to leave before we try stealing shit?
We're gonna escort him. Okay, I believe we're all gonna head as a group back home.
Okay, so everyone's sort of getting up, rubbing the sleep from their eyes, and Jaden is just leans the massive glaive against the wall and starts rolling back carpets. Gribble stops bouncing in the bed and he just kind of cocks his head and looks at you. Do you want to roll investigation?
I would like to, I suppose, yeah.
Yeah, go for it.
I mean, Asher's blood is probably on the carpets, so, you know, he could just be, you know, cleaning up for him. Get rid of the evidence.
Oh. Sorry, it's just been a little bit slow.
No, take it on.
Yeah.
That's a 15, not bad. So as you're rolling back the carpets, you don't find anything under it, but you see the way the bed is sitting on it.
Mm-hmm.
This part of the carpet here. As you get to the front left leg of the bed frame, you notice that there is a sort of a hidden panel there in the leg of the bed frame. Pretty much like right beneath Gribble, and he's stopped bouncing and he's just looking at you now. You all right there?
I try to distract Gribble.
You're doing a bit of cleaning in my fucking house.
Just looking.
For what?
Just looking. And I'll slowly stand up.
Okay.
But very much in the, I'm taller and bigger than you, but that's
fine. You're attempting to intimidate.
No. Just holding my ground. Holding my ground.
Okay. So he, Archie Trooper says, no ale under the carpet. He goes, right, so, did you find what you were looking for?
Found nothing.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Gribble has drugs in the bed.
Are we ready to go?
You two seem like you're becoming a fast friend. I know anything about relationships, I know that at least.
Oh god. I can just think of fucking Robert's next smut novel.
So all of the entire interaction went totally over Scale's head. So when Gribble says, are we ready to go? He'll pick up his stuff and he'll be like, do you want to walk or will I carry you? Because you're small.
Well, holy fuck now, I am small. My legs pump fairly well. I don't fancy a 2-day journey, but I tell you what, if I can sit in your shoulders, I'd be well up for that.
Okay. And
I won't touch your horns. I won't try and steer your head by your horns, right? You just go where you want to go, and I'll be the passenger.
Okay, but you probably should hold on.
I will, but just... Yeah, I won't cover your eyes, I won't hold your horns. I'll hang on to your ears or something, right?
Why would you cover my eyes?
I said I won't cover your eyes. I won't cover your eyes.
Okay, that seems like a very good thing. And without waiting, Scales is going to like pick the gnome up and sort of like lift him over his head and pop him on his shoulders.
Okay, plunk.
Just get some pails on your horns.
He's sort of just kind of scooches down there and wraps his legs around. He seems to have a good grip around the sides of your neck. You can see he's got quite strong thighs. And if there were gnome-sized horses, he would probably be a quite accomplished rider. And it's odd. It's, you know, you kind of find yourself wondering how he's, you know, how he has that sort of skill or knack without there being tiny little horses for gnomes to kind of scooch around on.
Just out of character.
Yep.
Robert better not be bad at getting ideas of strong thighs.
Robert always gets ideas.
I have no idea what you're talking about, and I resent that statement.
Okay, excellent stuff. So, are we heading to town?
While all this tomfoolery is going on, in between getting situated with his armor and everything, Limit's just going to again cast good berry, pass it around to everyone so everyone's got.
Okay. Everyone has a good berry, so note that, put it in your journal or in your inventory or whatever you like to do. Tyrion Shadowbane says, I hope Scales doesn't have spikes along his back. So does poor Gribble. Okay, cool. So I'm going to cut you all. Have we got everyone there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. Copy.
As Lamont gives me the good berry, I'm like, you guys ever noticed that sometimes too much of a good thing is a bad thing? Like, these are great, but I'm kind of hankering for some real food.
Well, no one said you have to eat it. It's more for an emergency.
Berries are food.
Of course. Yeah, I guess.
Okay.
You need to eat a lot of berries, though, to fill your stomach.
Yes, Scales.
It's better
than... eat more than one.
You'll get sick.
Only eat one. Yeah, no, I only eat one. You tell me that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Of these berries, but not other berries. Other berries, you can eat more than one.
Depends on the berry.
After you've checked them, yes.
Unless it's poisonous.
I don't eat poisonous berries, though.
Oh.
Why would you eat poisonous berries? That seems like a really bad idea.
You don't always know they're poisonous.
Why would you eat a berry that you don't know isn't poisonous?
I don't know, Scales. Why would you eat a berry that you don't know isn't poisonous?
Maybe it looks tasty.
It's the same like poking your finger in some sand and don't know what's under the sand.
Yeah.
That's totally different. That's sand,
or like,
not a berry.
You know, going up to random plants and, you know, picking them and stuff.
Yeah,
plants are nice.
Do you have a lot of experience in desert areas, Mr. Fenar?
Well, come from a long place, so tell me more about forest, then I can tell you anything.
Oh, okay. I've never been in a desert. I was just interested what it's like.
Probably dry.
If it's... Could be. How do you get out of the sun?
It's coarse and it's gritty and it gets everywhere. Hate sand.
Maybe you get out of the sand, or you get out of the sun by digging in and covering yourself with sand.
That's not a good idea.
Like when you go to the beach and you like only have your head above the sand.
Robert was taking notes, but then he's just like, no, crosses it all out. Like.
I feel like that's just going to cook yourself. Like, you might cook yourself doing that in the desert heat.
Right, are we ready to fucking go, lads? Or are you going to talk about sending that shite all day?
My question is that rune, like, glyph of warding still on the bridge?
It sure is, yeah. I was wondering when Fenar was going for his midnight walk, whether you guys were there.
So while everyone was talking, Ren has cast this, like, he walks up, like, gets close to the rune, and then pulls out his book, clicks his fingers, and there's like a flash of gold, and the rune just... As he casts
wasn't
spell magic.
Wasn't Scale gonna like body slam
Asher, you said I could.
He's dead.
Yeah, his body. You said that we had to kill him first. And if if I killed him, no, if I hit him twice, no, wait, there was something. And if Asher, if we did that to Asher, or if I did it to Asher, then I could throw him at the thingy on the bridge.
I mean,
and it obviously happened because he's dead.
I mean, I don't think you hit Asher twice though.
And then there won't be the thing that's going to explode on the bridge anymore.
I mean, I could just get rid of it with magic though. I mean, yeah, go ahead. Lamud, do you have something that can get us over the gap when Scales blows up the bridge?
Sitting on your shoulders, Scales, you hear it, you feel a little pat in your head. Well, it's a great fucking idea and all. I don't want to have to rebuild me fucking bridge. You know how long that took me? I'm good with my hands and all. Fucking hell, it took about 5 nights to make that, so it did.
Oh, yeah. That's a good point.
It'd blow me whole fucking bridge up, so it would.
So what can I do with Asher's body?
Leave it.
I tell you what, we can throw it off. We're on the third floor here. We'd fuck it right off the third floor and watch his neck break and the back of his ribcage just smash open. That's what you want
to do. His neck already looks kind of broken.
Do you want to fuck him off the edge?
Yeah.
Right, so hold on a second now till I go and find a fucking token.
I'm just... I don't want any part of that. Seems kind of gross.
For non-Irish people that might not get it, to fuck someone off something just means to throw them off something. Just in that case anyone doesn't get the slang.
There you go.
Well, the lingo is a bit weird. For me, I was like...
he's right there at the edge there, Scales.
To fuck someone into or fuck someone off means throw them.
Yeah, we got it. Yeah, cool. Yeah. So, Scales, what are you doing?
I'm going to lift up Asher's body and throw it off. My zoom... Oh, wait, no, there we go. My zoom is working now.
Yeah, you can move. You're going to move him out there. And you can move your token out there to where he is. And... can you make your way out? I'll just drag you out there.
Yeah, if you can, because I can't get it. There
sorry,
we go.
The door must be echo. Cool. All right. So, Scales, what do you do? Do you do a whole walk up and lift him right over your shoulders and just whoa? Or how does this go? Or do you just got to roll him to the edge and kick him off?
I'm going to lift him up, but in deference to the fact that Gribble is on my back, I'm not going to lift him fully over my head. I'm kind of going to lift him to about like face height.
Yeah.
And be like, one, two.
Go on!
Oof.
And you fuck him off, and he shoots over the side and lands with a sickening crunch right at the base of his spine, right on a massive rock there. And you just crack, and his body just folds in half backwards over the thing.
And I'm going to be over at the edge then, kind of going,
Well, are you happy now?
Yeah.
Good for you. Good for you.
He hit us. He hit us with fireballs and with a big, icy.
Would you fuck off with your fireball? He didn't hold. You'd be dead if he hit you with a fucking fireball.
No, he did. Then we had to go into the mine and everything was trapped, so we had to be really cautious. But I wasn't sure what we were looking for, so I just followed after the others.
Were you as cautious as you were with the trap in the door there to me fucking bedroom?
Even more cautious.
I'd say so. Yeah. It's not hard.
But he did. He was very bad. That's why he's dead.
Right.
I checked for traps, okay? I'm not good with arcane things.
So,
right, lads. Are you ready to fucking go?
Yeah, so while this is happening, Ren is going to... he's going to cast Dispel Magic on the bridge before we actually forget to walk onto another one. So he's going to...
Okay.
Like, golden strands of energy, or like magic, kind of starts... Like, kind of like strings start to come off his finger, and they slowly just unravel the rune on the bridge.
Okay, that looks pretty. That looks pretty cool. Everyone has never. I assume no one's ever seen Ren do this before.
No spell.
The Fenor is Fenor doesn't see it. He's just still in his 8 space. Like,
okay, what's cool. Going on? Yeah, Fenor seems quite distracted. Reprobate Gamer says a spin-off between the Dragonborn and the Gnome here. yes, your spell is it is successful, Ren. And you see those golden motes of energy just, as you say, just unravel this glyph of warding. And it just sizzles away, kind of motes of bluish and gold energy. What would you like to do? Are we ready to go?
If we start actually leaving the airship, getting to soil areas, I want to see if I could possibly tell which way.
I'm going to move you down to the bottom level. So we are now at the bottom level where we came in. And Gribble jumps off your back, Scales, and he goes, hold on one second now. He runs over here. And you can see him fiddling with some sort of, fiddling with something. And it's down at his height. And takes him about 2 minutes. He's running back and he goes, grand, fucking grand now. Be no one going near me shit now. Right, let's go back to town. Let's get a fucking fry up and get some beers in. Party.
I just want to see now that we're on the ground level, if I can tell maybe through footprints or something to like which way, what stiletto went.
Okay, roll survival.
Okay, dokey, give me a sec. I'm not super great at that.
That's an 11. Very hard to tell. You get the impression that someone this stealthy and this accomplished doesn't often leave very readable tracks.
It would not be smart to do that, yeah.
Indeed, indeed. Okay. Anyone else do anything before we leave?
For now, it's just like, how did this body... This body was at the top. How did it... never mind.
Yes, you're now beside the ruined body of Asher.
Yeah.
Does Robert see a little silhouette of a man? Very good, Architrooper. Very good. Excellent work, sir. Okay, anyone else like to do anything before we leave?
I mean,
happy to put this place behind us.
Yes.
Okay, cool. But I'm going to move you over. You guys walk for most of the day. And you decide a good place to stop would be, sorry, I'm after losing his hair. Where's my waterfall map?
So when Gribble gets back to the ship, it's gonna stink of dead Asher though. It's gonna suck.
Yeah, I mean, you would think so, yeah. maybe okay, by that so time. So I dragged you over there. You guys should find your characters there. We will see some new music here.
Stink of Dead Asher feels like a goth metal song.
Yeah, it does.
Stink of Dead Asher, yeah.
Do you guys see your tokens there on one side of the bridge?
Is this the bridge we crossed?
No, it's not. It's a different one.
It's completely different.
I also There's see no another trees. Token we probably shouldn't see.
He's off the map, though.
Half Elf on the Shelf says Asher to Asher, Dust to Dust. That was the name of an episode title, I think. Or maybe
it was going to be an episode. Yeah, it was going to be. I suggested Asher to Asher if we killed him, but it didn't happen.
Sorry, Dave. Eric mentioned it and I scrolled up the moment I saw it. Right at the bottom of the screen, there's a token.
We shouldn't probably see.
That was for something else. He's gone. Don't worry about him.
Okay.
Yeah, it's only worse things. I'm going to use this for a
different encounter.
He's gone. Don't worry about him. 5 seconds later.
Don't worry about that. It's all good.
Do I see my friend further?
You sure do. You sure do. As you guys, you've been walking for most of the day. And this music's a bit fucking crazy, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go for...
I turn mine down.
Let's go for Middle Earth Dawn. It's much nicer. Much nicer time. As you guys follow the path for most of the day, the journey's idyllic. You don't feel threatened. You don't feel worried. There's no trace of those displacer beasts that were away up on the other side of the mountain when you came from the mines. As you approach this area, you hear the sound of rushing water, and as you get closer, you can see it's a very fast moving river that's running down from a waterfall here. The road looks to be kind of relatively paved, and further on along, you can see some well kept crops, but no buildings around. Nothing. No signs of civilization other than these crops. And as you walk towards the bridge, you see a familiar sight. A gnomish fellow, clad in dark green and brown leathers, twigs and leaves that seem to be growing from his leather armor, flowers and daisies seem to be growing from his long white beard. His head, shaved completely, has some tattoos on the side. He carries a large staff. And he's walking along, thumping the staff along, thump, thump, thump. And he goes, well, my friends, as I live and breathe, Raytack, your old friend here, looks like you didn't die.
Just about.
What for lack of trying.
So once I hear the water, and even though Braytac is approaching and talking to us, Scales wants to just go off to the side and look for some leaves and branches and stuff, like twigs and...
Hold on to fuck now. Where are you going? Where are we going?
Just to get some leaves and stuff.
Why do we need leaves?
To put them in the river.
What?
To watch them go under and down.
All right, yeah, I'm into that.
Yeah.
Wait, so...
Run like an elbow for an hour and be like, stay away from the edge, pal.
So what Scales is doing. He's looking for like stuff to throw in the river to watch it go downstream.
Okay. Gribble will happily stay on your back. Lamod, you're walking up to Braytac, are you?
Yeah, just walking, you know, straight up to him, giving him the, you know, the beast master head shake.
Yeah.
And then just pulling him in for a nice tight hug, massive smile on my face.
Good to see you, boy. Good to see you.
You too, Braytac.
How'd you get on up there in the airship? I see you got the little one.
We got him. Honestly, not sure how long he would have lasted if you didn't help us.
He's a talker. I'd say
he doesn't shut up.
I'd say. Yeah, right, boy. Yeah, I hear he could talk for the whole kingdom, Sophorum. But yeah, I figured he came talking now and then till they tortured his treasure stash out of him. You guys find a treasure stash?
Depends what you mean by treasure.
Oh, little fucker there loves hoarding gems and coins and all sorts of shit. Legend has it he's got a king's ransom up there.
Over where I am with Chris,
as he was leaving, he made sure that a certain part of his ship was locked tightly.
Mm-hmm.
And as this is happening on the bridge, I'm over here and I'm like holding stuff up to the air above my head to sort of say like sink or float.
What is it? what is it though? I can't fucking, what is it? Is it a leaf or a stick?
That's a leaf, okay?
And the leaf will float.
This is a twig, but it seems dry, so I think it'll float.
That'll fly. That'll fucking float, for sure.
And then I go back to looking for other things.
Right. Try that pebble there. It looks hollow.
Hollow? Oh.
It looks hollow.
Okay.
Right. What are the rest of you doing? Or are you happy to let Lamod take this encounter?
I'm just feeling a little nostalgic looking at Scales playing the game that the kids from back home used to play, just in the river.
And you can see it's pure joy in Scales' eyes that...
They also enjoyed it a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well now, boy.
The Spicer Beasts.
I tell you what, deal's a deal, boy. I need your help up here. Not right now. I'd say in about 10 days' time. Need you come up and help me with my giant problem.
No, that
we indeed have a big problem.
That is
well played.
Half Elf on the Shelf says, Dave, you need a cowboy hat and a holster for this segment. Maybe next time. Also, if anyone wants to see the full map for the airship, it's a map. It's just uploaded onto all our social medias. And they are all now at It's a Map IRE. Lamud.
All right. To Braytac, you know, we promised we'd help you. Nothing has changed from that, but it's just something we need to go take care of in town first.
It's all good with me, boy.
We should be back before the 10 days are over.
I'll tell you what, I come calling. It's time for you to pay your debt.
Will you find us in town then?
If you're in town, I'll find you in town. If you're outside of town, I'll find you outside of town.
Fair enough.
I got ways and means.
It's not ominous at all.
I'm just going to give him a knowing nod.
As you've been traveling for, about 8 hours now, it's getting pretty dark. And he nudges you with an elbow that seems to have some thorns and briars growing out of it. And he goes, "See up there, boy." He points to the stars. "Them there tell me everything I need to know." He gives you a knowing nod. Limud, and he heads off. "Well, I tell you what, I've had my friends do a little patrol of this area. I reckon you're gonna get yourselves a good night's sleep tonight."
That is very reassuring. Are they still in the area?
"For now," and he heads off. "Don't do it, and I wouldn't do."
as he leaves, Ren turns to Jaden and be like, "Not sure if them being in the area is a good thing. They didn't seem too happy to see us the first time."
"Probably didn't seem too happy to see you."
"I mean, they tried to. There was one trying to go after us from the bottom of a cliff, versus when we encountered them."
"We.
Maybe they just wanted to say hi."
"Oh, they look hungry.
What would you like to do? Where would you like to make camp?"
Is there any area specifically that looks better than the rest?
That's high ground.
You can see there's a previous kind of remains of a campfire up here. And it is a slightly raised area.
Star Wars has taught me anything. You always take the high ground.
Oh, so they're towards, on the other side.
The top left of the map there.
Yeah, I mean, that looks decent enough.
Okay. Gribble makes his way up there and starts pulling out some beef jerky and stuff like that, and he's tucking into it, hoping none of y'all will see what he's got. "Oh, it's fucking good. No, I tell you, it's too fucking cold. I should always give yourself a fucking fry." "Oh, I was." You can see he kind of shoves it in under his armpit. He's kind of holding his arm there, and he goes, "All right, what's the crack with you now? Yeah, right there, Robert.
Just
that is your real name."
"It's probably not your real name."
"I saw.
Some people call me Seth, but I don't like being called on my middle name."
"That sounds pretty evil. It sounds like one of them evil names. If I was a bad guy, I'd call myself Seth. So I would."
"It's not necessarily evil."
"Then it sounds evil." "Well, now,
it just means appointed. So,
right, so I take your word for that. Who's making the fucking food? I'm starving."
"I'll start the fire." And French clicks his fingers and then campfire, I suppose.
"Holy fuck! Well done, lad. That's great work."
"I can't cook for sure.
Are we eating rations or what? You're gonna go out and catch us something decent."
"I think we should stay close.
We could fish.
Yeah, even though the displacer beasts are out there and we've been told it's safe, still, I wouldn't take too much of a chance."
"Displacer beasts aren't all bad, though.
They're dangerous." "No,
I'm not saying the displacer beasts. I'm saying something could have snuck past them."
"Oh.
Yeah.
Is that a cave there, Dave, by the way, with the mushrooms, or is that just indent in the map?
Pinger there. No, that's an indent in the map."
"Okay, because it's kind of hard to tell. Just with the, cause it goes dark and it looks like the mushrooms are going under the rock."
No.
"So the caves are in other places, I see."
"Oh, Archetrooper says, Sith, coincidence, I think not."
Does anyone else see the face on the waterfall? Anyone else see that at all? It looks like a dwarf.
I believe the person who I bought this map off is in the chat. So
Kate, you drawing this you Easter drawing egg? Dwarves in the waterfall.
I think this is an Easter waterfall. Egg.
Oh, look, who's this now? Who's ruining the map? Who is that now? Look at the colours down there. Anyway, so what's the story? Is everyone just tucking in for the night on trail rations, or are you going out fishing, or are you going out hunting?
I'll just eat the berry.
Like, Scales is inclined to go foraging and or hunting.
Mm-hmm. I'll go with Scales on that. Yeah.
Okay, excellent. So, Scales and Jaden, how far are you going? Are you going out, like, leaving the map and going for an hour, or what's your plan? Or are you just going to forage this area for berries and
I think gerbils? Scales is inclined to stay in this area and see what he can catch.
Okay.
He doesn't want to go too far from the party.
Okay, cool.
But if Jaden is sort of like, no, seriously, we should go a little bit further, Scales is probably going to go along with that.
Okay, so. Excellent. So, Jaden, your call.
I think he would probably want to stay close. He doesn't necessarily trust the friends of the druid overly much. But I suppose do the scan of the area. If there's nothing substantial,
okay.
I mean, it's not worth the risk at the moment.
Cool. You can either boat roll survival, or one of you can roll survival with advantage. You guys choose.
Go for it.
I will go for survival with advantage. Let me find the advantage toggle. Survival.
Not bad. 17. 17. Okay. Through your foraging and through your hunting, you managed to find a good few handfuls of quite tasty berries and things like that, but also two rabbits.
There's also just like crops over the other side that no one could have stolen.
You can steal people's crops. You can certainly go picking. From the orchard, as it were. It's not exactly an orchard, but you get the reference.
Before Jaden and Scales went off with Fanar, we'd just like turn around to say, Jaden, you guys can go. I'll just keep an eye on you.
Mm-hmm.
I can see quite far, so don't go out of sight. Safety reasons.
Good to know.
Okay.
Have any of us noticed that Fanar is acting odd? Like, last 20, like, since you woke up?
He's right there. You're going to say it in front of him?
No, we're not. I'm not saying. I'm like. Has it been like? I'm asking. Like, has it been like noticeable? Like that he's not himself.
That's up to that. That's up to Fanar. Yeah. Fanar, have you been like noticeably off?
It was just. He's always quiet, so he's not really off for anything. He's just distracted. So.
Suppose.
He's half elf on the shelf says orchard full of poison apples. Do you think I'd do that? Do you think
yes.
I'd do that for them?
Yes.
Probably.
Okay.
You did mention a devious trap, so I'm kind of like on edge about everything.
I don't think you're going to get to that tonight, but we'll see. Okay, so you're hunting. You guys return with a good few handfuls of very tasty berries and two rabbits, which is a lot more than you had.
Can I, as we're coming back, mm-hmm. I suppose stop Scales before we get back to anywhere near camp, but I suppose just kind of halfway mm-hmm. through. And I just want to go. Scales, hold up for a second.
Okay.
I want to apologize. When we were in the mines, and we were taking a rest, and you were asleep, and I was on watch.
Okay.
I reacted badly and kicked you to wake you up, which isn't, I suppose, a fair way of doing that. And it was in heat of the moment, and I just wanted to apologize for that.
And you see this complete look of like, wait, what?
Yeah.
Did he? Did I get kicked? I don't remember this. Did I get kicked? Did he kick me? He probably did. But I don't remember him kicking me. Would I notice him kicking me? I don't know. I probably should notice him kicking me. And I'm just, when you see all this kind of like, what? And then eventually Scales will just shake it off and be like, okay.
Good. That's right. That was it. I just wanted to make sure that was said.
Okay. That's very good. That's very good. Is. You're a very good person.
No, I'm not, but let's keep...
No, you're good. You're my good friend, and I'm glad that we're doing this adventuring and saving people and helping good things happen together.
Yes.
And eating bodies off of airships.
Good. I'll clap him on the back and we can start moving again.
Cool, Abula. Let me just do one thing. Yeah, cool. Okay, so you guys make it back, and you, as you sort of walk down this path here and cross the bridge and stuff like that, you can see everyone's heads turn in anticipation of, were they successful? What did they get? Are we any more shit trail rations tonight, or what's happening? You guys
hold up the
arrive back.
So Jaden will hold up one pristine looking, expertly glaived rabbit, and Scales will hold up a totally smashed rabbit.
Morningstarred into pulp. So it looks like the only option tonight is
roadkill rabbit, you know.
Stew.
I just think Jaden would have shot the rabbit with the crossbow more than like stab it with the blade.
Well, maybe a crossbow, but something precise and like, you know, shot through there, where it's like smash.
Excellent, excellent.
I'm visibly disappointed when they arrive because I didn't know they were looking for food. I thought they were looking for firewood, and I already ate my good berry, and now I'm kind of full.
Everyone's like eating the good berry. Fucking things, man. They work so well, but it's just not the same. It's just not the same. So, cool.
So, just to add insult to injury, I'm going to hold out some berries to you, Robert. As like, we also found these berries.
I'll politely take the berries and thank you and eat them.
Okay.
I'm just watching Robert this whole time.
I'm waiting for my map to reload, but it doesn't seem to be doing that.
Yeah, mine's a blank.
So as you guys set up for the night, I assume it's rabbit stew with berries for starters and dessert, and our trooper says they're very good. And anything, are you guys gonna set watch, or are you gonna trust Braytak and just have a nice
trust Braytak, I would recommend that we set a watch.
Great.
Yeah, for now we'll keep take the first watch as well.
What, the first 4 hours? Because you only need a 4 hour rest.
Yeah, we'll take the first 4 hours.
Okay. Okay, so who's taking the first watch?
Me.
Just you. I'll go with him.
Okay. That's cool.
I'll take second watch.
Okay, so you guys are just sitting there together. Your first watch is as the last remnants of the sun sink below the horizon. The stars begin to shine in all their glory. The sound of the rushing water from the waterfall and the river rushing past. It's the most idyllic long rest you've taken so far. And it's, for some of you, it conjures up images that you may have imagined when you were told stories of heroes past. And when most people are told those stories, they don't imagine the driving snow and stinging sleet and overcast nights. For some reason, all a child imagines is nights like these, and this is one of them.
How's the new stick working out?
It works quite well. Did some damage with it. But still need some practice.
You were quiet on the way here.
Yeah, just a lot on my mind. How do you feel after opening up that chest?
I am starting to dislike fire a lot more than I have previously. There's been one too many explosions right in my face. Lost a nice beard.
Yeah, his beard is looking very patchy.
Yeah. And yeah.
And can we all hear this? We're all sitting around the fire.
We're asleep at this stage.
This is first watch.
First watch, okay.
So they I would imagine that they're talking quite low.
So we can't see anything, movement or anything?
No, your watch passes uneventfully. So then anything else you'd like to say to each other, go for it. Otherwise, we'll move along.
Just like that before, like, and I'll just tell Jay, just like, we have to just watch our backs a bit more, I think.
Surely the danger has passed a little bit.
We can hope so.
What do you know?
Stiletto just... He disappeared, so he can't get any reinforcements or anything. So you should just watch out.
Hmm. Okay. Yeah, no, Jaden's not going to push because he's always on edge anyway, but he's like something was there, but he doesn't know what.
Okay. Is that it for you guys? Okay. Second watch.
I'll take it with Lumwood.
Okay. Move your tokens or go to wherever you wanted to go and the map.
Take it same as well.
Okay. No worries.
What's the highest point on the cliff? Oh, nice. That's not one of us. It's probably not nice.
That was me. Okay.
Yeah, so the limit would probably, you know, strap the armor back on, strap the shield to his arm. Yeah, it's just sitting on the ground cross-legged, you know, arms kind of halfway crossed, you know, like that, with the shield arm on top. Which, by the way, is the Crosbrier shield that he's...
Oh, excellent. So he's taking that shield that he found. Good to know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Ren's just still kind of in his... his jacket's still kind of over by where he was sleeping. He's just wearing his shirt and normal clothes.
Okay.
And, he has a spell book out in front of him, and he's also pulled out a small hip flask that he's been occasionally taking a sip from throughout the watch.
Yep.
He offers it to Lamud at some point. I don't know what happened there.
Yeah, I'll definitely take it.
What's in it?
It's whiskey. Not shit quality whiskey. Like, really, really poor.
Yeah, I'll probably cough it.
It burns in the way down and not in a good way.
Somerton's finest. Okay. Tavern.
I never expected someone with liking for fire to keep flammable liquids so close.
You'd be surprised how useful it comes to have it on you. Back in Raven's Nook, there was a murder in the tavern I was in, and first time I used magic to hurt someone, couldn't really fire a firebolt back then, so I splashed a glass of whiskey in a guy's face and create flames. It's a nasty way to go. So, plus, just, takes the edge off sometimes. You tend to see some shit as an adventurer that you want to forget. Like, that shit with Asher's body was a bit much, if you ask me. Like, he was a prick, but didn't need to throw him off a balcony.
He deserved it.
He deserved it, but, you know.
But that said, sometimes it's
gruesome sight.
Sometimes it's better not to forget, but to remember.
Mm. Sometimes I'm one to talk. I've done some, as you guys have seen, some pretty stupid shit the last few days. But sometimes doing something like that just makes it just as bad as they are, I guess. Well, maybe not just as bad, but you get what I mean.
I understand what you're saying, but as long as you do what you do from a good place, I don't really see anything wrong with it, but... maybe sand down the edges sometimes.
No, I get you. That stray fireball towards that bandit probably
stray
overkill.
You have to aim that shit.
Edlabud is actually going to chuckle at it.
That Ren is intentionally making a joke there. So he's, yeah, he's making light of a serious situation, I suppose, trying to take the edge off. But
and it's at that moment you hear, ah! And you look up and you see...
It's that bandit.
No, what you see is a horrifying sight. You see... some contraption made out of wood and look like leaves and gears and pedals, and there are two there it's about 40 feet above you, and there are two what look like gnomes sitting in two seats wearing these weird goggles, and this thing has flapping wings and it is just
clearly out of
control, and they're like, pull up, press the fucking thing! Ah! And it comes down really low, and then they kind of fly off to the west, and luckily a thermal or an updraft takes them, and they go right back into the sky. And one of them takes off the goggles and looks back and goes, sorry about that! And they
fly the like right over us?
Yeah. Well, like about 40 or 60 feet up.
Oh, okay.
I'm just gonna sit there.
Does it wake the sleepers?
Oh, it would wake you all, yeah.
Fucking gnomes, man.
I look over to Grubble.
Those
friends of yours?
Fucking idiots out there in that fucking gnomish city to the north, Cram's knocking from Nogafar. They're lunatics. They're always making these mad fucking things. They're obsessed with flying. I don't know what the fuck it is. Flying and digging.
You crash a fucking airship?
Yeah, you had a big...
My airship fucking crashed. I didn't crash it, right?
You can't talk.
Now, shut your fucking hole, right? My airship crashed. I didn't crash it, right? Now, anyway,
you all want to take ships that should be on the sea and put them in the air, though? That seems like a crazy notion.
Hold on now, you. Hold on there 1 second, right? You see the difference between an airship and a sea ship, right? I don't have to fucking run tar and all that shite along the sides so the water won't get in. I just fucking build it and it goes in the fucking air. And I'll fucking tell you now, it was flying around the place for a good nigh on a few year before it crashed, right? So
why is
I had perfected the art of flight. I'll have you know. These fucking idiots trying to fly with pedals never fucking work. They're mad into digging as well. You want to see them? Under fucking ground, they've got these things with drills on them. They're fucking peddling like fucking lunatics, and they're digging through the mines and through the mountain. God knows what they'll fucking wake up down there.
Sounds like they could give a dwarf a run for their money.
Anyway, I'm glad they're gone.
Do they ever put plugs in things?
What does that mean?
Like a plug, you know, like a plug.
In the bath, like?
Yeah, like in the bath. To stop the water going down, but when you take the plug out, something comes out instead of going down.
I mean, that thing you almost killed us all with.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
I just pulled the plug and then the thing came out, but apparently it went away.
It's like a spider in the plug of a bat and in.
Well, if the spider was made of black goo, then
black goo. Obviously, somebody had drilled down. And they found something.
Hold on now.
And then they put a
Are we talking about your inn? Or are we talking about somewhere else? You need to give me context here because you're rambling.
You're
the mines.
There was a big
fuck. You didn't pull out that plug, did you?
Scales pulled out the plug.
I pulled out the plug. Why not?
Oh, fuck. And you're still alive.
Well.
Yeah. For now.
He walks over to you, pokes you. You are still alive.
We threw a body in it and it kind of just shriveled up.
But then when we came out later, it was gone away.
I don't know what it is. I tend to avoid it. There was you see, I used to go up there now, and I used to go up to those mines, and I used to go up and dig out crystals with my dagger, dig them out, and that's how that went. And I'd come down, then I'd bring them back to the air. Said long old fucking journey, but I do you know what? I made this little thing, right? Made out of three baskets, right? And as I would walk, there was a pedal system on it, like sort of a lift. And I step in the lift and the baskets would move. And then as the momentum went up, the baskets would propel me along. And it was going uphill because it'd be really hard. But if it was flat ground, it was great now. You can tell he's just rambling like he was in the boat. I mean, I can RP this for an hour, but I don't think we need to.
Like when you put a plow on the back of a horse so you don't have to like dig the hole yourself.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah. I was up in the mountains one night, right? And that fucking plug was, it was out. And all this black shit came out and it started moving towards me. And then I saw a hand, it shaped into a hand. And it tried to grab me, but I run like fuck into the mines.
Did we see a hand? I didn't see a hand. Did you see a hand?
We didn't.
It's a map, says cast silence.
I don't, I was about to cast, I was considering casting a whole person on him again.
Yeah, he fucking ran like fucking there, I tell you. But you know what? It came after me. But it stopped dead square at the entrance of the mine, wouldn't go in.
But it's okay. I put the plug back in, so it's okay.
How do you know? Tell me you know it went back in there before you put the plug back in.
Well, it wasn't there.
Because if you put the plug back in and it can't get back in, God fucking knows where it is now.
Oh, no.
You're sure, aren't you? You're fucking sure.
Well, it wasn't there when I put the plug back in. So... I'm not dealing with that mess.
Some other Avengers can deal with that.
No, we need to deal with that.
This is not.
Telling me there's a possibility that this thing is now not down the hole and they now cannot get back down this hole? Because when I went out about a day later, I even fucking slept in those mines because I was scared shitless of the fucking thing.
Well, where else would it go?
It was back down the hole. What?
It didn't leave the hole.
You know, the weird thing about it was a day later, I came out and the plug was in.
When we came back out.
No, I know, but I'm telling you that when it happened to me and the plug was out and the thing was out and it went for me and I ran into the mines and it couldn't get me. Then I slept in the mine for a day and then it came back out. The plug was back in. The plug's fucking bigger than me, like.
Are you suggesting that potentially this thing plugged the hole back up after it went back in?
I don't think so. I searched for traps. There were big footprints. I think something let it out. I think something put it back in again.
Humanoid?
They were, yeah. Bipedal.
Braetex Giants, maybe?
I don't know what the fuck it was. Braetex, what? Who's, what? Braetex Giants?
Yeah, Braetex wants us. It's a long
story. I don't think he lives anywhere around those fucking mines.
Just remember, everything looks bigger for you.
Yeah, say. True.
Are you being fucking racist?
Yes, I'm just, the lord is just like trying to get some sleep because he didn't have a nice sleep, so he's getting irritated. That's why it's just like,
right, so look, I don't know if I'll sleep because those fuckers, they come back again, but you look at, let's see if we go right. Resty, who's taking the next watch, or is that 4 and 4, or is that 2 and 2?
It was 4 and then it was
4 and then 2, and so there's 2 left.
Right, so 2 more. Who's taking the next watch? I'm fucking dying. I want me fry. I want me fucking ale. Come on.
Suppose it's...
I can take the watch.
Yeah, it's me and Scales.
Right, so. Now, don't fucking wake me up now. And you can see he crawls right beneath this fucking big kind of tree bush thing. And he wraps the branches around himself. And he's like... straight away.
Before Ren goes back to sleep, he'll like turn to the party and he's like, we could just leave him here.
I fucking heard that.
We can't. We have to bring him back and we have to make his wife.
I fucking heard
and
that.
And him have
right.
the confrontation. Like, when they talk.
I hate
the feeling she's... Yeah.
I knew you fucking shit. I'll be doing that in private. It's not going to be like some play in the middle of town. Put on for you. It's my private life, you shite, yeah.
And we still have to bring you back to her so we can get paid. So
I went to get more donuts. She'll pay you.
Where'd you get to? The fucking big fella, Kronk.
From Kronk, yeah.
He makes some good donuts. Tell him I sent you.
So you deal with your wife and we'll get donuts.
Sounds good. Okay, so you guys are taking the next watch.
It's not a conflict I'm going to miss.
19. Okay, cool. Grant, this next, do you guys want to engage in any discourse or back and forth?
I was only hoping to ask Scales if they know how to read.
I can read. I can read lots of words. I'm not so good with writing the words. I was never very good, but I can write. But it's very messy. And Scales will show you, he'll pull out a piece of paper and show it to you that has like purple stones, black, killing everyone. But it's written in that really like 3-year-old scribble scrawl.
Like using a pen like this.
Imagine if I went into paint and I did it with the free paint tool. So it's like, you can see that it's letters, but they're like really all over the place and they're messy.
Do you like reading or not really?
I like stories.
I have...
Don't traumatize Kales.
I have a story you could read. It's something I did in my university time.
Does it have big words? If it has
some of
big
them
words,
are big, but if you don't understand, you can ask me and I'll,
yeah,
I'll be
okay.
happy to.
Excellent. I'd like to read. As long as I can ask you what the big words mean.
Of course. And I'll hand Scales the work that I did for my final paper in university. If she wants to read, if he wants to read that, then.
Do you have anything with Dragonborn in it?
I have honestly never seen a Dragonborn up until.
Me.
Gale's roll an insight check with advantage.
Advantage, insight, where are you? Oh, well, 10.
That's enough. This resonates with you intensely. Sorry for distorting the mic there. This resonates with you intensely. And, sorry, I'm going to just my mic there. Yes, it resonates with you intensely, and you can't help but think back to the vision you were shown by your ancestral guardians. The vision of some sort of doomsday magical artifact being harnessed for catastrophic results. The eradication of an entire race off the continent of Sophiron. And your mind casts back to that night above the vertex crux, a mountain range that separates east from west, as you saw for one brief moment, lines of magic connecting every single dragonborn to this center artifact, and then all at once the lights just go out. And it seems to you this is why nobody has seen many dragonborn right here.
So university, that's like school, but even more school, right? So, and you were there and you wrote a thing. So,
like school for big people.
I need to find out about a thing, but I don't know where to find out about the thing.
And I might know exactly where to find out the thing.
Exactly, you
out
might.
Out of character, like... I might really exactly know where to find the thing.
Out of character, I think you do. But in character, I also think you might, because you've been to the big school.
Nice.
I had a dream, and it wasn't a dream. It was like a dream, but like an even better dream. And I think I know why I'm the only Dragonborn I've ever seen, and why you've ever seen, and why it seems like anyone's ever seen. And I have to find out why, but I don't know how, because, well, before this, I used to be a farmer. So,
What did you see in your dream? Was it like a...
They killed everybody. Well, they killed all the Dragonborn.
Sorry, Scales. It was a dream. But you know it was more than a dream. You were shown something that happened.
Exactly. It was a dream, but even more of a dream. Like, it was even more than a dream. Mm. And it happened. And
like
it's why I'm the only Dragonborn anymore. Or maybe I'm not the only one, but there's no Dragonborn everywhere. And they killed them all after there was a big battle, and then they killed them all. And there was this stone thing, but it was made of purple. It was like purple, like, and he pulls out the purple stone he got in the mines. It was like this, but not this, but like this. But it looked like a flower. And then they killed, I think she might have been a queen, or she was like the major battle lady, and they killed her. And then all of the Dragonborn in the
Dave,
cave.
Do I know anything about a big crystal purple flower thing?
You do not. I'm not even going to let you roll for it. You do not.
So they were in a cave.
Do I know?
And there was all the Dragonborn, but they turned to dust. And then all these, and you can see Scale doing this motion, but he has no words for what he's trying to describe.
He definitely
doesn't. Strings, and they went up, and it was black, and it was purple. The flower was purple, and it was made of
sounds exactly like someone describing their dream to you.
Pretty much, yeah.
Exactly. It should be.
Turned to dust. Are we fighting Thanos?
It went up, and it was black, and then all these strings came down, and then all these lights went out, and I think that was all the Dragonborn. And I have to figure out, I have to find out what that was, but I don't know how. And then he looks at you with these massive Dragonborn puppy eyes of trust.
Robert, I'll allow you to roll one insight check on this.
I have theories. It could have been some kind of arcane super weapon or like maybe a disease of some kind. Six.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they're theories, but just theories.
Would I know of any wars with the Dragonborn?
Yeah, I mean, the history of this continent is that let me get my royal family out. History of this continent is that King Artex, the King Artex the first, hundreds of years ago, liberated these lands, not cleansed them, but you know, there was a massive war as humans sort of filtered into this land. This used to be Dragonborn land, and the common history taught in school is that after, you know, long and protracted battles, the humans and the Dragonborns came to a peaceful accord, aided by the elves, and the Dragonborn were shown away to ancestral lands, and went there peacefully.
That's ancestral land in heaven.
That's pretty much the vibe that everyone thought. There's no, you know, obviously it sent a certain way to us as players, but there is, you know, it's King Artex the First is celebrated as a peacemaker and a diplomat and a wise and benevolent overlord.
Now, would I know of a place that would have a more in-depth history of that time period? Like some kind of library? If not, it wouldn't be in a smaller place.
If it's a library that contains books that go against the sanctioned history of Sopheron, it may exist, but it would not be tolerated. So,
and all
I
this
mean,
time, Scales is may, still looking at you with big puppy eyes.
They're glistening.
I mean, I have been kind of speaking out loud my thoughts in this sense.
It's very clear Scales is like, he hasn't talked to the others about this yet. He's been mulling on it. And now he's like, he's spoken to you about it. He's like, you're going to save this for me. You're going to save me in this regard. You're going to show me the way.
I feel
that's
like
probably more psychotic than like big eyes.
I feel like the answers we're looking for, I won't find in the places where I'm used to looking. Maybe we should consult something different, a different force.
Could you help me write it down? If I work with you and I describe it, can you write it? Because I've only got, you know, and he shows you again, purple stone, big flower, army, death, kill everybody. He shows you his notes, which in his pigeon scroll are not going to obviously help much. So he obviously wants to.
And you think, Robert, that you could probably work with Scales over maybe a period of, you know, several days and several nights by just sort of trying to corral Scales's ditheriness and focus on, you know, start at the start and not, don't jump to three quarters of the way through, back to the start, and just you know, just kind of push them for detail and detail and detail and try and focus their storytelling. This will probably take a few days and a few nights, and we'll roll a few dice for it.
I can even do you one better than just writing it down. If you describe it well enough, I could probably draw it.
You could, because you draw all the things.
Wow.
So yeah, if I get it wrong, say no, that's not what it looks like, and make it more like this, and
that would work even better.
Very excited about you guys walking around with the dark history of the kingdom in comic book form in your backpack. Because fuck knows that's not going to get you in trouble. And that is where we'll take our break, guys. See you guys in about 10 to 15 minutes. Thanks for joining us.
Stick around.
Thanks, everyone.
With Bergen's Book of Beasts and the cosmic horror adventure Firestar Falling, get over 200 new beasts for encounters, familiars, party pets, character companions, and of course, Polymorph and Wild Shape. And new subclasses, including the College of the Jewett Bard, Oath of the Pact Paladin, and Way of the Sacred Beasts Monk. And how about dozens of magic items, including items for your animal companions and familiars? And don't forget about Firestar Falling, a 100-page cosmic horror adventure with rules on how to make twisted beasts that will scare the living feces out of your players. Live on the wild side. And back the Bergen's Book of Beasts Kickstarter now, because there's a little bit of beast in all of us.
Welcome back to the Software on Saga. Thank you everyone for sticking with us for this very lore heavy episode, and putting up with my my St. Patrick's Day country leprechaun-esque gnomes, and that's canon, that's how they all talk now. So as you guys finish having a chat about possibly, you know, creating a comic based on the dark history of the Empire of Sofron, you guys come to, and your long rest is over. You successfully rested, and it is time to make a move. Anything anyone would like to do before we leave this area?
Check the skies for gnomes.
Check the skies for gnomes. Gnome sign of anyone up there.
Casting Good Fairy again.
Okay, Casting Good Fairy. Did they only last for 24 hours or?
Yeah, only 24 hours.
Okay, cool. I just thought you were just like continually fucking handing people good berries and like, do they have six?
Ryan is constantly taking like rotten good berries and just planting them in the ground.
Cool. So, as you guys leave this area, I'm going to bring you back to Templetown. You guys make your way back into Templetown. Now your characters are probably all over the place, so just tell me if they are not, if they don't have the correct hit points, then we can tweak that. You guys would enter from this area here, so up the north there. I'm gonna move your characters up here where I will shift and ping. See that?
All right.
There you go. So knock your characters there. And as you walk in, straight away out of the blacksmith, walks up a little young man with a guitar.
Fuck off.
There he is now. There he is, the failed wizard. The wizard who can't cast a spell. The wizard. The wizard who tried to shoot a firebolt. And he missed a hit and barely burned an house down. Red Orum.
How does he know my surname? I've not told anyone that.
How indeed?
I'm just going to whisper to Ren. Remember Rough Edges.
Do what I did to Gribble on him?
What'd you do to Gribble? What'd you do to Gribble? Oh, shit, I better copy and paste him over. Hold on 1 second.
Gribble, you know exactly what I did to you.
I assume Gribble's on my shoulders.
He is, and I will do that now. I will give you control of him. Let me just go back to the waterfall. Copy and paste the poor little bastard.
I can't help but for a second he started talking to us because he wouldn't show up.
There he... Where are you, Scales? I'm going to pop him there, and then I will give you control of him. 1 second. So you can stick him on your back. Gone. No, sorry, it's this guy here. That was a scribble. Sorry, here we go. In and edit. In players' journals, scales, and can be edited and controlled by scales. There you go. So you should be able to control him now.
I can.
Excellent. So you can put him in your back and you can drag and drop and make them too. And Gribble's like, don't mind that little fucking shitehawk. He's a little prick, he is.
He's kind of good, though.
Your stummer. Hey, Arthur, don't make me talk to your fucking outlet now. Fuck off, right? Arthur.
For now, I just want to check if we can see a small rock or something lying.
Yeah, there's loads of them.
Don't throw a rock at the kid.
He just takes the rocks back after it and take that. It's like, okay.
I want to hit him just as bad as you.
I just want to...
All right, sorry. Arthur's like, sorry, Mr. Gribble, sorry. I just don't like him. He's a wrong'un, you know? He's a fucking wrong'un. And he heads off into the market. And you can hear him kind of... You can hear that guitar going...
Someone needs to teach him a new riff.
Scales is going to poke Ren a little bit and be like, you're a wrong'un.
He's lucky it wasn't his house that burnt down. Keeps talking, it will be.
Jesus. And as you make your way into town, just around here.
Please no.
It's Kronk!
The apothecary. All of the kids are lined up here. We just move a few of them over. This guy's over here. I'll just use him for the moment. And you guys see a line of about 10 or 15 kids all outside the apothecary. And they're like, ah! And you just see Kronk just throwing them up like a good 15 feet in the air. And he just catches them. And then just outside... coming down here and standing beside them here is a familiar figure from school. And he's like, oh no, please, Mr. Kronk. Oh no, we can't, don't throw those children so high. Oh no, oh no. And they're like, higher. And he's just throwing them in the air, 15, 20 feet. That's gonna roll, see if he drops one.
Please.
That is a 4. And as he throws this one in the air, he sort of lets go of the left-hand side a little bit longer, and the child begins to spin in the air, and it goes off to the right, and you can see Kronk going, and the child begins to travel.
Can I run to attempt to catch this child?
You sure can.
I got nothing to help here.
Let's have an acrobatics check.
I'm just using my
I want to say Fenar will like try to help.
Oh, but if too many of us try to help at once, we're gonna do the thing where we smash into each other.
Yeah.
Dope rogue shit.
That's a 12. I think that's enough. I think that like that's enough. So you can see Kronk going, and he's reaching out his hand as if the thing is like the child is right there, but it's like a good 10 feet further apart. It's at this point you can sort of see Kronk's eyes, or depth perception probably isn't his thing. You run across and psh, just catch the child. You land heavy in your arms. Your heart's gonna go down. and almost hit the ground, but you just kind of managed to capture them. And Kronk's like, laughing his hole off there.
Just to remind you guys, I have a strength of -1.
Nice. And then the next child's like, me next! And he's just like, no. Game over. No. And Kronk's like, whoa. And he kind of wanders off then.
Rumble Tooth anywhere to be seen?
And no. There's a great smell. There's an awesome smell coming from Baker.
Scales is going to follow with Gribble on his shoulders. He's going to like immediately take off after Kronk.
Scales, we need to bring Gribble back to his wife so we get paid.
What? But
Kronk's about here then.
Donuts.
Yeah, but money.
But donuts.
Yeah, but money. We risked our lives for this money. I kind of want to get it.
Gribble, do you want donuts or money?
Archer Trooper says, nice form, but a little rough on the landing. They may have to settle for bronze. Gribble's like, I tell you what, Scales. Enton would have to fucking face that bitch of a wife of mine. Let's go get donuts.
We'd you get donuts first.
Donuts fucking forever, Scales.
And
let's
Scales
do it.
Scales is going to keep going after Kronk.
Ryan will wait till they're out of earshot.
Are you just running or shouting after him?
He's just kind of like, he shouts back towards Ren about how we're going to get donuts first, and then he just takes off after Kronk.
Are you just chasing Kronk, or are you calling his name?
No, he's just kind of following after Kronk.
Okay, Kronk walks around from
the bakery.
He walks around the back of the bakery. And he's kind of, as you run around the back of the bakery, he's kind of fumbling with locks. And you can see now that the door is ogre-sized into the bakery. But it's, you know the way there's a half door in lots of country houses? This door is like a three door. So you can, like a normal human would just undo the bottom two parts and walk out and leave the top part unlocked. But obviously Kronk has to undo that part as well and walk out. And he's kind of fumbling with the locks. And he turns around.
Have you seen those
donuts?
Big barn doors?
Unk.
Donuts.
Donut.
Yeah. Donuts.
Donut you?
Yeah. They were awesome. They were amazing. They saved my life.
Donut you.
And Scales is gonna kinda like hold out a fist for like his tiny fist compared to Kronk's massive fist for like a bump, which is like awesome. You saved my life, dude.
He looks at his fist and he's like, He just holds it up.
Scales is going to bump it.
Okay, looks unsure. He's never had a fist bump before. And he's like, Donut.
Donut.
Come back. 2 year.
2 years?
And he disappears inside. And in that, at that moment, little, where's his fucking,
come back in 2 years for your donuts.
Pretty much. Let me just that
was well.
Save you from broken Scales heart.
Yeah.
Randall will say to Jaden, Scales, after Scales and Gribble are out with earshot, he'll be like, you know, I can see why his wife wanted him dead. I don't agree with it, but I can see why.
Divorce is an option.
True. I mean, the better option, but like, I get it. I was a shittier person.
One second, guys. As he says that to you, Scales, outside of the bakery, a little head pokes out. Scrundletooth. He goes, hey, who are you? Oh, it's you, you prick, yeah. He's looking at Gribble. I thought you were fucking dead. I hoped you were fucking dead, you little fucking skittery prick, yeah. That you're back again, troublemaker. Making all things a fucking blow up and fucking kill people. Well, I tell you what, I was just coming out here now, you Dragonborn, to tell you that when he says two, he means four, and when he says years, he means hours.
Oh, okay, because they were amazing donuts.
It takes longer to fuck. Well, you're getting fuck all now. You're getting fucking nothing because you're friends with that little prick.
But now I have...
Look at you parading around on top of people like you're the fucking king shite.
But no, ignore him. I have coins now. I have coins. And what? Scales doesn't quite understand what, like, the difference between gold, silver, and copper are. But he has coins now in a little pouch. And he's like, but I can buy some donuts now.
Okay.
Because the donuts were amazing.
Right, well, he's unlikely. Well, I can't tell him not to make them. By telling me he shouldn't fucking make them for you. Go back in a couple of days. They might be there, they might not. Get that fucking thing off your shoulders now, it'll be the fucking awful streets of shite on your fucking back of your neck. Little skittery prick. And he disappears inside.
This is what Gribble does
with my head. I'm going to leave Scales. I'm going to leave Scales and Gribble there. You guys, what are you doing?
We go in with him? Or
the rest of us.
Where are you going? Yep. What are the rest of you doing?
I would just like tell the Robert. Good catch. That was nicely done.
Honestly don't even know. I kind of just acted on instinct. I don't even know.
Why did I? It's like the second time you are full of surprises because of last encounter. Then you went from one side to the other side really quick.
It's hard to explain. I don't know if you'll understand. Sometimes it just feels like things just kind of slow down. But
where did you learn that?
I don't know. Just kind of there. I mean, I've always had a quick mind, but...
Quick mind, and for now, just like take one silver piece, just like flick it to Robert to see if he catches it. Think fast.
Start of hand. Dexterity check.
From who?
Just a standard dex check.
Contested dex checks.
No, just roll a dex check to see if you can catch it.
Oh, okay.
Ren, what's your passive perception? 17. You catch it.
Oh, not high. It's
11.
20.
20. Well, yeah. Hang on, Ren. One second. Proficient. You catch it straight away, and you're just like, it doesn't. You know, it sort of goes wide, and you're just like, psh. You catch it. Going to Ren. What's your? Can you beat and a 16 stealth?
Definitely not. But the question: does passive perception, does that increase with your proficiency bonus or no?
It depends on whether you're... No, it shouldn't, as far as I'm aware.
It does.
I'm not proficient. If you're proficient in perception, isn't it?
It is your modifier plus your score. 10 plus your modifier, so...
10 plus your profession, so perception modifier, which is a wisdom. Yeah. So, plus your proficiency if you're proficient.
Yeah, I'm not. Yeah. Actually, that was...
Okay, cool.
Who's spoke about me?
Arthur Summers comes up. And there's no typical but you get an immersive kick up the hole. Bam! And it's one of those that he gets a toe bog right in your arsehole, and you feel it in your throat. And then he's here's a song for you now, you wee prick. And he runs off down his houses. No points of damage, but
The second he turns 18, I'm murdering him. The second. I will show up to his birthday party and use a fucking light from the candles on his cape to burn him alive.
Oh, I thought you'd just shoot him with a fireball and say, blow out this candle, bitch.
Okay, so what are you guys doing now? Fireball, are you heading, you're just going to head for, to take your ease? Are you going to go to the apothecary?
Can we go to the apothecary without
Of course you can. Yeah, you're going to say your boy's back in town and try and...
Boy is back in town.
Actually,
I think we should. It'll be interesting. We can confront her.
Jaden, you had the note, didn't you?
Did I have the witch?
The note from...
Yeah.
Should we tell her we found her husband in pieces?
I think we should confront her about the fact that she's trying to murder her husband. While he's not there, just in case things get messy.
I mean, is there a need to create a scene?
I mean, she's kind of the worst.
Husband is definitely elsewhere getting donuts.
Now is the best time to confront her about it in case she does try to kill him.
But is there a need for us to create the scene?
I mean, to be fair, her husband did say that he wants to deal with it his way, and technically he is the wounded party in this.
But I also want to get paid.
I mean, we will get paid. If we don't, we report her to the authorities, and then we make a scene.
And we didn't sign the contract, so like, reporting her to the authorities isn't going to get us paid.
Let's not forget, good was done.
Good was done, and that's important. But like, I owe Arthur like 40 gold.
You fucking found hundreds of gold in this last adventure.
True.
Yeah, I've been looking over the...
We didn't split up... I don't think we split up the gold at the very end.
You put it in the party loot.
It's not in party loot, but do you know how much we got? Because I checked and it wasn't there.
I thought it was all in party loot.
I thought it was in party loot as well.
Nobody's taking care of the party loot.
No one's putting in party loot. I was looking
at Robert.
We had the three gems worth 150 gold pieces.
What's the party loot? You're supposed to care about gold.
150 gold pieces. No, I'm going to have to go back to the stream because I rolled for that.
I divided mine and Jaden's that I know.
But what were the two splits?
You still have the green gem that you yeeted down the fucking hole in there. Someone needs to take better care of the party. I'll have to go back to my notes. I can't tell you right now, but it's you guys definitely have hundreds of gold pieces.
Yeah. But we'll deal with that after we can record.
Yeah, you better. Cool.
I think...
the green gem is out of the party loot now.
Yeah, good. Yeah,
I'm also going to take the stuff that people are wearing out, like my silver dagger of returning.
I had the boots of Winterlands on.
Thanks for the follow on Ninjasteen 3108.
Did Jaden equip the Elden Chain?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
Okay.
He only equipped the ring of plus one.
Mm.
Yeah, but the Elden Chain makes him sneakier, so...
Can we say that dagger that's unidentified really
I would have identified the magic dagger that we didn't identify in the end.
While our time in town, we don't need to worry about who has
which one. Daggers plus silver dagger returning plus one dagger one. That is a dagger of venom.
Dagger of venom. Okay. Yeah, Robert, we would have given that to Robert.
You look sneaky here. Have the poison dagger.
No, like, as in Robert actually throws daggers and has used poison in the past, so, like, he's the most likely to use it. So.
Cool. Right.
I just want to say...
You're sitting around the town just, like pouring out your bag and just, like, going, that's yours. People are walking by going, what the fuck is going on here?
I just want to say that Ren can also wear the Elven Chain.
Huh?
Yeah.
What?
It's not... you are considered proficient with this armor, even if you lack proficiency with medium armor.
I mean, if Jaden doesn't want it, I will take it.
It's elven chain mail, not an elven chain shirt.
Oh, yeah, it's chain mail.
Oh, it's chain mail?
Yeah, elven chain mail.
That's a different story altogether, sorry.
Did anyone take the leather armor plus one?
I think you did.
Yeah, I thought you did.
No, I took the studded leather.
Oh, okay.
I think I can wear leather armor then if Robert doesn't want it, because he insisted he didn't want the gross armor.
I took no armor.
You can press to digitate the shit out of that.
Yeah, I did press to digitate the shit out of it already.
I'm already wearing leather.
Yeah, but it was leather, plus one leather.
Leather plus one.
I honestly think you'll be better off with it.
I have a complete image of us sitting, or well, ye all in the town square.
Yeah, that's what I just said. Yeah, pretty much. Like, you guys are saying, that's yours.
Can I even wear plus one leather armor?
Actually, no, it'll interfere with your spell casting.
Yeah.
Bernard is just laughing at you guys because
one of the guards walks up. One of the guards walks up and goes, "I'm sorry, could you do this elsewhere, please? You're attracting unwanted attention."
Maybe I suggest you would take
some rooms at the Shadows Rest in or somewhere that isn't here. Thank you.
Well. Just all of us just stare at him. None of us say anything.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, we can do this.
Thank you. Oh. So you're heading into the apothecary. Who's heading to the apothecary then?
Let Robert go first.
Everyone, Scales and Gribble are out here.
I'm gonna
move you guys to the apothecary in 1 second. Scales, out from the church, walks a familiar figure.
Dickhead, is it?
The not nice man that you threw a donut at and skulled in the head. And he's walking through the gates of the church here. And he's like, not the temple. This is not the temple. Temple Town's named after. That's a 2-day trek to the north. Sorry, west.
So before he arrives, after the whole scene with Kronk's keeper, who I can't remember the name of.
Grundletooth.
I'm going to be like, are you a bad guy? But then I see this guy walking and I'm like, oh, he is a bad guy.
We assume. Probably
and
right.
As he approaches, he goes, "I'm sorry. What? What am I?
You're a bully.
I'm a bad man, am I?
Yes, you're a bully.
Delighted
you tried to bully that dude to have his thingy.
That is property of the Kingdom of Sulphurone. Everything here is property of the Kingdom of Sulphurone. I think you'll find you." Our property of the Kingdom of Sulphurone.
But I'm me.
Indeed you are. And he shakes his head.
Something tells me Valder knows exactly what happened with the Dragonborn.
The innkeeper owns the inn, and the apothecary owns the apothecary, and the church owns the church.
Yes,
so how are we property of...
And then the kingdom owns all of that. You see, we disseminate... How can I put it to you? We give everybody little jobs, you see. And the person who runs the inn runs it. But they pay some taxes. What are little shreds of what they make goes back to the kingdom. Because we allow you to live in safety, you see. This is the beauty of being a part in the bosom of the kingdom of the Sulphurone. Don't you see, little outcast?
And you see all these does not compute running across his face. As he's like, and eventually he lifts out his Morning Star and he holds it in his hand. He's like, but this is mine.
Yes, indeed it is yours. But should the Kingdom of Sulphurone require your services to defend it, then we shall point you in a direction and you will fight for us.
But it's mine.
Yes, it is, and it will remain yours.
Okay.
But you are ours.
Why?
Because you are a citizen. Of Sulphurone.
But why?
And therefore, you have responsibilities towards the kingdom. I tire of this bullshit. Goodbye.
I don't understand.
Wraith.
But why?
Wraith. Come. And from out the door, the person that I don't have a token for right now, Scales, you see walk a massive for a Goliath. Massive.
Oh, are we talking like 9 foot then?
You're talking Goliath? 9 foot tall Goliath, dressed all in furs. Missing one eye. Walks out carrying this massive, massive glaive. And as he walks out, you can hear it's hitting soft earth. It's like as if you can imagine like a chancellor's staff on hard tiles. It's just crack, crack, crack as he walks along and he goes, yes, my master. Late time we went for a walk, isn't it? And so Valder walks through here. Through the town.
Does he come by us?
The apothecary, he does. And
in
quick step behind him, this massive, massive Goliath, wielding a glaive like a long sword. He's just walking along and he's just like spinning it in one hand. And he's like,
As he approaches, if we're like kind of in his way, I'll step out of his way and I'll also give him a salute.
He looks at you. One second. Want to give him an inside check for this?
Was Robert doing it disrespectfully or just like a...
No, not at all.
Yeah, so...
Is it 26? What's 8 on that? And he's like, looks at you and goes, where's Robert? He goes, ah, the army man. And he gets into a tight salute.
So they do salute like this, okay.
Yeah, good to know. For now. And if you'd like to sort of talk about the lore, we can say that they do something else. But yeah, until then, he just salutes. And as he walks along past the two of you up to here, you can see the massive Goliath with the glaive just sort of lets himself hang behind, and he looks at you and goes, and just takes the piss out of you, and then just walks along after Valder.
I was rude.
Very.
And trailing behind them as they went was Scales with Gribble on his shoulders, looking absolutely, totally fucking confused.
Like, Balder comes back and taps Jaden on the shoulder.
Who on the shoulder?
Jaden. And he goes, my friend, don't forget our deal. Why don't you be jolly good folk and go and find some runes for me? Unless you have already. In which case, I'm happy to part with some gold for you.
Not found anything.
Well, I suggest you get to it then. Chop, chop. Wraith, we're heading north. Oh, sorry, he heads this way, I understand. He goes, Wraith, we're heading northwest.
Sorry, Wraith.
That was a DM mistake, not a character mistake. So there you go. Let's not dwell on it.
It's one of those.
Valor and Wraith head out northwest, and they are both dressed for travel.
Towards the temple.
Yes, towards the temple.
Looks like they're leaving town anyway, so we don't have to worry about those. He
said he owned me. Or, no, he said.
Let me guess, the crown owns everyone and everyone serves the crown or some bullshit like that, right?
Yeah, sounds about right.
My morning star, and I'm still holding it because I'm very visibly confused looking at it. He's like, this is mine, but it's also not mine. It belongs to the king or the kingdom, but it's mine, but it's not mine.
Scales, don't worry about it. He's just a prick. Pompous asshole. Likes to throw his weight around.
And the inn is the inns, but not the inns. And the church is the church, but not the church. I don't understand this at all.
So, let's say I borrow you this coin.
Okay.
So, now you kind of have that coin.
It's my coin.
It's kind of yours. Yeah.
Yeah, but I owe you this coin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of in the same way. Everything under this blue sky in the land of Sophron is the king's.
Because he borrowed it to me?
It's his land, yeah. Think of it as him borrowing it to you.
Then, okay. Okay. And
you don't necessarily have to give it back until he really needs it.
I'm just moving you to copy and paste you. So
Scales is going to go,
okay. And then you can see him sort of visibly kind of go back and try and think, I have no idea what this means, but I'm going to think on it for a while.
Randall, that's why, like, you know, people who aren't adventurers pay taxes.
Okay, what's the plan? Are you guys going to go into the apothecary? Are you going to force Gribble in, or are you going to go in beforehand? Or are you, does, you know?
Does Gribble look like he doesn't want to go in
he
there?
He does not want to go in there.
Then I will outright ask him what he wants to do. Does he want to simply disappear?
Do we tell her he died?
I don't know, Lamont. Like, does she really want me dead?
Yeah.
Like, holy fuck, like, do you know what I mean? Like, she's after cheating on me. Which you want? What?
Do you want us to find out?
I don't know, but like, my heart's broken. She killed my heart. She killed my fucking heart already. And I don't know, did she? Like, whatever about cheating on me, but oh, God. She hurt me that much and she wanted me dead as well.
I've not been a great husband.
I know that. I've not been a great husband.
Because Gribble tell you what?
I poured myself into my work a lot and I might have neglected my marital duties already, but...
We can tell her you're dead if you want. We don't have to tell her, we can show her.
What?
I have...
He says threatening.
Magic at my disposal that can make you... appear as if you are dead.
What? Wait till I dare, like, as a fake corpse? While she tells ye the truth, and I'm not supposed to react to it. Is this what you want?
You could join us.
You won't be able to react.
Be an adventurer.
I'll be out for the count. Well, is that how it goes?
Can I just?
You will appear dead, but you will be very much alive.
I don't like the sound of that.
Can I?
The fellow with the big stick wants to talk.
Yeah. So, he's already been paraded through the town.
Yeah, actually, good point.
On the back of a dragon board.
Yeah, but Valor saw.
Maybe it might not stand up to scrutiny.
I'm just giving an option. I'm not saying that's what we have to do. I don't think it's an option.
Maybe we could recommend them to couples counseling or something.
Archetrooper says not so much dead, just unalived.
But I like our little friend. I mean, we shouldn't let her kill him.
I mean, Gribble, we could, like...
Who did she cheat me?
Gribble, how much are you willing to pay for us to get rid of the guy she cheated on you with?
What? No.
No, I'm just... No. Just trying to find a figure.
No. The answer is no.
Okay. No, I'm sorry to tell you. Here.
But if she wants to kill you, what are you gonna do?
Well, we could kill her.
No.
Listen to me. No. Felia is the norm. That girl, Felia's a woman.
Oh.
Felia is not a fella. Now, come on. I know they're spelled similar. But not that it should be important, but it's not a guy that you're looking for. She's cheating on me with your one from down the road.
I mean, that might explain why she's cheating on you. Maybe she just doesn't like men anymore.
Why did she fucking marry me then?
I don't know, maybe... people can change.
What?
People change.
Maybe you should just tell her you're not married anymore.
People change. People fucking change. But you don't hire a bunch of bandits and a fucking weird ass fucker called Stiletto to fucking murderize you.
We don't necessarily know whether she hired them.
But you know what? 100%. Fuck this. We're going to find out. And he marks
it. Problem solved. Rand will follow in mind.
Drag you over. To the apothecary. Bum ba dum ba dum. Here we go.
I have my own.
Don't move. We, don't anyone move anyone. I'm going to delete your characters and just.
I will laugh if we catch Felia's in here. That would be the best thing ever.
Oh my god, I'm not RPing that shit.
You just walk in and you see Felia growl at me.
And he goes, so you guys are at the door, he kicks the door, BAM! And it doesn't move at all. And he comes back and he goes, Jane, will you kick that in for me?
Look down.
Give it a kick.
Nod and give it a kick.
I need you to step aside as soon as you do. Step to the left.
Me step to the left?
Yes, so it looks like I kicked it.
Yeah, I'll got you. Okay. Yep. Kick. And
boom. Well, you fucking slag, you. I fucking knew you wanted me fucking dead. And Ewan hops up in the counter. He goes, by the fucking gods, tis yourself, is it? Jesus, tis myself. So you hired bandits, did you? You hired bandits to take me out and fucking kill me. By God, Grilda, I thought we were better than this. Now listen. I didn't hire them. I swear I didn't. It's all a big misunderstanding. It's like a big rock to roll down a hill in the snow and became a bigger snow mama. She starts crying her eyes out.
Inside check on that.
Yeah, on Grilda.
I want to get in on that.
You're in the room, so I won't give you disadvantage. Roll your inside.
Ren is in.
Are you in the room? You're in the room. 16. Okay. It's everyone just like staring at her unerringly, like their eyes boring into this poor little fucking gnomish woman.
I have gone searching through my pack for the note from Stiletto.
Ren's pulled out the materials to cast Hold Person if necessary.
Okay, no worries. Scales good
has
to know.
Come back over to the flower bed with the weird sand, with the weird thing that Scales. Wanted to eat him.
Oh, I started that out and showed it to Jean, so I hope you do.
He has gone back over.
Okay.
He is not yet touching.
I'm not saying anything.
Yeah, roll a perception check. Scales, please.
So the Hold Person's also being readied in case Scales needs to be helped.
Well, you can keep your eye on one person, more or less.
He's like, oh, Ren's eyes just dart between. He's like,
that's a 22 Scales. You see, like, one of these things is mostly sand, and you see some sort of something just kind of burrowing its way around. But you see a small disturbance on the top of the sand, kind of like the sandworms in June, but like it's really small.
You just see this big smile on. He's not touching because he knows better now, but he's like.
Okay, cool.
This is amazing.
Yeah, cool. So who rolled insight? Robert, you rolled 17. Ren, you rolled 16. Scales, that was your perception check. But no, she seems on the level. She seems on the level that something happened and you get the vibe that, you know, she may have asked for one thing and then shit went fucking way south.
So, Grelda, first things first, what the fuck did you have to do?
Shut the fuck up, you! I'm talking to this little prick here. And she wipes tears.
Is that her or him?
Grelda. It's Grelda, sorry. I'm gonna have to... Hey, so she talk like that? And he'll talk like that now. Right, so just so we can differentiate it. Grelda, well, you know... All right, look, I'll tell you what happened. I was coming home. I was going home from the airship. And I was beset upon by a load of bandits, and they were like, give us your stuff. And I was like, give me my stuff. Fuck off, you shite. And then they were like, well. And then they were like, oh, well, I'll kill you now if you don't give me your stuff. Why? Like that. I can't do the accent, but something like that. And they're like, and I said, well, I tell you what, if you let me go, I'll tell you. I'm ashamed of it. I'll tell you. My husband's come back from the mine with a load of crystals. I told him where and when he'd be. To save my own skin. Also, in the hopes that I'm ashamed to say that they'd take him away. And I'd get to spend the rest of my life with Frelia. I'm sorry, Gribble.
She didn't want me killed.
I didn't.
I don't fucking believe you.
And he turns to Robert and he goes, do you believe her?
Most of it, yeah.
I swear it's true. I swear. And then they came to the town and they said they fucking had you. And if I didn't keep making poisons for them, they'd kill you. So I made poisons to keep you alive. I swear. And then the adventurers came through and I hired them.
Never said anything about him being taken by bandits, though. kind of an important detail you left out.
She's on top of this counter and she looks at you with dagger eyes.
Sounds to me he almost sent us to our deaths as well. Jaden's beard.
Ren, roll a wisdom saving throw.
Yep. That's not down my own thing. Sorry, I only have an intelligence save down there.
Oh, look.
Not one.
Oh. All right. For, like, whatever about the wisdom saving throw. Are you... I know that you took the telepathic feat.
Yeah.
Are you okay with receiving telepathic messages?
Oh, definitely.
Okay, so she looks at you. So that was with the wisdom. I was giving you an opportunity to block this out. But you hear a voice inside your head. And she says, if I wanted you dead, I'd poison the fucking stew in that shithole you're staying in. Remember that.
Can I tell that she's intentionally trying to mess like do that?
100% she's singling you out because of what you said.
Noted.
I'm sorry, Gribble. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Can we... I know it'll never be, but... we'll try and be friends. Fucking friends!
But wait. And Scales looks up from his perusal of the worm and he's like,
don't put your finger in there.
If you don't love him and you don't love them, why would you send us up there?
I presume just to know that the bandits don't still have him.
You wanted to know he was dead.
What? I didn't.
You outright offered to pay us more if he was dead.
So if he
No, I think you'll find I have to pay you less. I would pay you less if you recovered the corpse and more if you rescued him.
But then you would know he was dead and you could tell everybody he was dead and then you'd does she get to own all his stuff if he's dead?
Yep.
And this is to the rest of the party.
Hell, Scales with a deep dive fucking legality here. Holy
pretty
shit.
Sure that's how that works, yeah.
So, you Scales, didn't God, know he was
litigation
dead.
Here. That's amazing.
But you wanted us to prove he was dead, and then.
No, I wanted you to rescue him.
If he
come
was
on, my little
dead,
dragonborn, lovely. I love you. I wanted you to rescue him.
And
I said, if you couldn't rescue him, bring back the body, and I'll give you half, so I could give him a decent
burial. Yeah, but you
in my crops.
You wanted him to be dead, and if we proved he was dead, then you'd...
No, I didn't say I wanted him to be dead. I said
Scales,
I wanted you to rescue him.
Looking around everybody else like, this is the limit of Scales.
I can just smell the smoke.
Never doubt the ability.
And she turns and looks to Robert, and she goes, I'm arguing with the wrong person, am I?
Sorry,
Jaden,
what?
Jaden, have you found the letter yet?
Yep, I have it right here.
Sorry, Dave, what did they
What's
say?
This? She looks at Robert and goes, I'm arguing with the wrong person, haven't I?
I don't know.
Nice.
I'm
so,
very
Jaden, you pull out the letter.
Yep.
And I will go to our handouts, note mm-hmm. from Stiletto, and how do I just click show the player, isn't that right?
Yep.
Cool, and it should pop up there. Yep. Let me just zoom it in. I don't know if I click on it as well, would it get bigger?
No, I've got it.
Something Christian.
So it says, Asher is in charge until I get back. Gone to the airship with the gnome. As agreed with his wife, only one of us will be coming back. At least we won't have to listen to his incessant prattling anymore. Don't give Asher any shit or you'll end up in the third level of the mines. Ain't no one come back from there. And he took the time to sign it as well, says Stiletto.
So specifically that line that says, as agreed with his wife, only one of us will be coming back.
So
I don't know what that means. I swear to God, right? Oh God. As agreed with the wife must be that I continue to supply them poisons and to keep him alive. I didn't ask him to kill him. I didn't. I just wanted to.
You made a deal with Stiletto.
I did! To keep him alive! I continue supplying poisons!
But if he came back alive, then Stiletto wouldn't.
What?
Is that what the note says?
Here, you need to get this fella out the fuck out the door here. Give him a book or fucking some colouring pencils or something. I don't know what. I'm talking to the wrong... Hey, come here, you fuck off. You. She walks over here and goes, I'll talk to you. You make more sense. She goes over to Tillamud.
Gribble. What's going on now? If she made a deal with Stiletto and only one of you or Stiletto was going to come back, does that mean that Stiletto's not dead.
Ash, the rest of us, the rest of us are just looking so proud at Scales for like.
But Stiletto's not dead.
I can smell the smoke coming out of their ears.
There are some grinding gears.
It's just that scene from Fresh Prince. They're a little confused, but they got the right spirit.
Yeah.
So Stiletto's not dead, but you've come back. But only one of you was supposed to come back alive. And Stiletto isn't dead. So does that mean she was... I don't know what that means. What
didn't
does that
say
mean?
Anything about them being dead. But if one of them, if only one of them was coming back, and she, and the agreement was that her husband would come back, then there would be no need to send us.
Exactly, yeah.
It doesn't really add up.
Someone
is not telling a certain part of the story.
I'm watching her, Dave. If at any point it looks like she's gonna like attack unleash a spray of needles or something.
Roll an insight check there, my friend.
Can I aid with that? Because like since that
no, you can't because he's the one who said it.
Yeah. I'm doing
and
it.
And during all this. Like,
hold on, let's get the inside check. Eight. Okay, good to know.
No, she's not lying.
Hold on. The inside check is to suss out her body language and you said if she looks like she's about to attack. That's what the inside check was for. Okay.
During all of this, Scales is like he's talking to the air and also upwards towards where Gribble is. So he's like
I think Gribble's hopped down at this point.
Gribble's down.
Gribble's down.
He's standing on this side table here, which is slightly higher than the table she's on, and he feels like it gives him a bit of more authority.
Who's taller, Gribble or Gribble?
And she's looking. She's facing Lamud now, and she's sort of. She's very deferential, and she's like. Oh, my little tusk-toothed friend, I swear, I didn't mean to kill him. I wasn't trying to kill him. He caught me. I told him where he'd be on the way back and how to get him, and he had the crystals and stuff like that. And then they said to me that if I didn't keep giving him poison, that they'd kill him. And I was like, what am I going to do? I had to keep giving him poison. He said that they were going to ship it back to the capital city. All the poison, I don't know what it's for.
Does she seem truthful?
Scales, what's your insight?
Barely anything, but
that's eight. Hard to tell. There's just too much going on here. Lamud, you can roll insight on that as well if you wish, but.
I'll try one more insight, yeah? I don't want to roll too many.
No. She's, you know, there's one more, and that's allowable. Six. And it's hard to tell. It's just too confusing. But it, you know, she doesn't seem the type that wants him dead. What you get from your 11 is that.
Does she seem happy?
What you get from your 11, right, Lamud, is that her encounter with the bandits on the way down. She probably. Sold Gribble's ass out to stay alive, and then realized as she was talking to them she could probably sell him out, and she might have hoped something bad happened to him, but she, you know,
she doesn't
it's
really...
hard to know. Mm. But you know, it's hard to know with the 11, but you get it's 50-50. It's like 49-51 that, you know, she didn't want him dead, but if something happened to him, you know.
So yeah, Limit is still quite a bit taller than her even when she's standing.
Oh yeah, 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 big time.
She's gonna look down at her and say to her, "You did this out of self-preservation."
As you say that to her, she goes, "Here, stick," and shouting at you, "Don't want you go back there."
No. He was turning around and leaning on, just looking for something to lean on.
Okay, don't want to go back any fucking further.
You could lean on me.
She looks at Ren. She looks at Ren. Ren, you're not strong.
Limit says that.
I didn't. I didn't want him dead. I fucking swear I didn't. Gribble, I love you. I still love you. I'm sorry I'm not attracted to you anymore, but me and Felia, we got a thing going. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Gribble, but I didn't want you dead.
All right? I'm just going to look over at Gribble and say to him, I'm sorry for your loss, and then I'm going to walk out.
Before you walk out, put your token back there. She reaches up and puts her hand behind your head and comes in real close to you, Lamont, and she says, "You be fucking careful about who you tell about this. I have you banged to rights by you and your pals by an illegal fucking poison off me. I'll go down for the fucking poison cell. If you accuse me of murder, I'll fucking take you down. I'll hang with you, you fucking tusky prick."
Do you hear this, or just between them two?
No, she leaned just, right into him. You hear that?
Just still walking out, leaving.
All right.
So Gribble, what's the move?
Oh, well, it ends well, isn't it? Gribble, look. I tell you what, lad. Fuck off out of my shop. We'll sort this out ourselves. Here's your money. How was it?
50 gold.
I think it is 50 gold, isn't it? Move to my notes. TTIP, TTB, quick notes. Felly isn't on the Gribble. Well, there's 50 gold. Yeah, 50 gold.
When you're done, Gribble, booze
is on. Drops a sack of 50 gold. Clunk! Hits and lands on the ground.
As Scales moves to go out of the room, Scales is going to stop by Gribble and sort of say, "She didn't seem that happy, really, that you were back. Maybe you should come with us. I."
Scales just wants a
and
bed.
He glances at the wife and then looks back at Gribble and like, I don't think it's good for you to stay here.
Gribble jumps up and he grabs Scales around the neck and he's hanging on to Scales' neck and he gives Scales a hug and he goes, I know, but I have too many inventions on the go. I can't do that in a move. We'll split the shop between us. She can have the shop and I'll have the airship and we'll work something out. But thanks.
But you'll be safe.
I will be safe, but I love you. I love you. Thank you.
I'll see you again.
And he gives Scales a big strong hug and he climbs down. He goes, "I never forget you."
Scales will give a nod and then head out of the shop.
On the way out, Ren will say to Gribble, "We're staying in the shadows, rest, as long as we're in town. Feel free to meet us there."
Devon and Arthur, fella.
Yeah.
The door closes and you're fucking bitch! And there's just this like, rah, rah, they're going at it.
Time to go, guys.
Okay.
Sounds like so home.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
As Robert exits, I'm just gonna pull him aside a bit and tell him, I think you should get rid of that poison.
Actually, yeah, Ren will also let the party know that she threatened to kill them if, you know, they said if she wanted us dead, she'd have, like, she could kill us. So,
okay, so where are we at? We have, you guys have more or less solved what, well, you're letting Gribble and Grelder resolve their issues, but, like, there in the apothecary. You know that Valder and Wraith have headed northwest towards the temple. And no one's checked up on what's going on with the Carved Witch and that.
Yep.
So let me get an intelligence check from Scales and from Jaden, please.
I would say me, and then you're like, never mind, he'll pass.
No, you weren't there. I'm trying to figure out who was there. Shit. Okay.
Unholy good intelligence check from Scales.
Scales. It occurs to you that Valder and Wraith were based in the church. That's where they've set up their their whole operation, and they've left on their travels.
Guys.
Yeah.
Wraith. The mean guy and the dude with him, who's also mean, probably. Mm-hmm. But also thinks they own us, but I'm not sure. But anyway.
Yeah.
They were at the church before.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're gone.
So you're saying you want to break into the church?
We could find out what's going on at the church while they're not here. And that, because they're not here anymore. They're gone.
Yeah, that's a point.
Robert, do you think you could scope it out? Check if there's anyone sneaking around. You're the sneakiest of us all.
I could check it out.
Shit.
Or we could just go there because they're gone.
We don't know.
They might not be the only ones here.
Yeah, exactly.
And you do remember there were a few acolytes or people with them.
I don't know about you guys, but I don't want to get in a fight with his men in the middle of the town. So I think maybe...
Again, we bring in here, the better.
What if we say that he said that we should go to the church?
I don't know if they'll believe us.
Met him on the way out of town, and he said he was very busy over there, and Scales points the way that they went. Because Scales isn't sure what is in the way that they went. But... that they're very busy over there, so they sent us to help protect the church.
I don't think that'll work.
Who's good at lying?
It's got nothing to do with us.
What a great question. Who's good at lying? The first person that puts their hand up is like, oh, really?
I mean,
I don't think we should be poking our noses in their business. We could go there if we find a runestone, if we have a reason to be there.
Wasn't there a thing about the church?
It's the temple.
Not the temple. Like,
oh, the thing about the church, Arthur first told came us they were
town and they, Arthur one told of us, the like, goals a pile was of taken stuff, away. Wasn't one of them about the church?
The one thing I will say, I'm probably sure that Jaden would have taken a look at the glaive that Yamana's walking around with.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So I will give you a description of this, and I meant to do it earlier. So the glaive is constructed from a dark, almost black wood of indeterminable type. Affixed to the base of the blade is a large white plume. The base of the blade, which is the top, a white plume of thick white hair that seems to blow as if in a constant breeze. There is no breeze today.
It's a glaive of blowing.
The butt of the glaive is tipped with an iron shod that sports a nice, nasty spiked hook. And that's something else that's important to put out there. That the white hair hanging off it was almost defying gravity.
But I do remember we wanted to look at the church. I don't remember why, but I remember we wanted to look at the church, and now they're gone.
It's so because Arthur like told a good us time. They were poking around the church.
So now seems like a good time to go to the church when they're not there.
We, Scout, honestly, we've made a couple of waves in this town already.
I don't think, yeah, that, I mean, yeah.
I don't think it's, I'm not saying it's not a good idea to go to the church. It's just not a good idea to go to the church right now.
If we want to find something out, we'd be better off probably following them to the temple, because well, that's in that direction. I assume that's where they're going. But I don't know about you guys, but that big fucker looks like he probably messes up if
we got honestly, I'd like to get rid of some of this extra weight we carry.
Yeah.
And then go after the carpet.
Oh no, here comes Arthur.
Okay.
Ren, so, you hear him coming this time.
Fuck off.
No, he's sneaking through the bushes to try and give you another kick in the hole.
Yeah, I'm out of the way. Like, I've moved as he's gone.
We'll get you again, you fucker!
I'm just going to think in his general direction.
Oh, shit. What are you going to say to him?
And I'm going to say, you're going to fucking die, kid. Just think it in his head. Get in his direction, just traumatize him.
So you're just going to fucking telepathically tell him that you're going to fucking murderize him?
No, okay, maybe not that.
Let's be exactly clear about the telepathic method that you're sending him.
Yeah, no, maybe that's a bit harsh. It's more of a like...
Oh, he's being careful now.
Yeah. More
only everyone had a DM to moderate their fucking base urges.
More like a,
maybe just threatened to break his lute or something.
Yeah, I'll break your lute.
I didn't say flute. Okay, cool. She said, "What? So tell me what you're saying to him.
I'll break your lute.
To the medium of telepathy. You're gonna break. I'll break your loop.
Yeah,
I thought he was saying, "I'll break your loop
over your head. I'll break that loop over your head." Near me again.
Okay, you see his eyes gonna cross a little bit and looks away, and he obviously doesn't know how to reply telepathically, so he just runs.
You can't. I don't think with telekinesis I have to allow it. Like I have to set the channel.
He cannot reply to this message. Yeah. Cool. All right. So what is the plan? What are you guys doing? Are you gonna head for the Shadow's Rest, or are you going to do some more wandering around town?
I want to
play I've got, well, in the party loot, which I'm assuming is the spare backpack that,
the what? Sorry, John, you're a bit far off, Mike. What are you saying?
Backpack that we got, which is basically the party loot right now, we've got the elven chainmail, 3 gems, a set of leather armor, a set of studded leather armor, 4 scimitars, 2 dagger gauntlets, 7 throwing daggers,
partridges in a pear tree.
And the kitchen sink that we got off the airship.
Yeah. Cool.
There
was a haul of gold as well, I thought that you had, but doesn't matter.
We don't know the exact amount. I don't think we forgot to write it down. So
Because I've got gold in my inventory, I think we've actually been dividing that as we went.
I remember the last bit we didn't though. Because we specified we'll deal with this after, because we're in the middle of the fight.
We'll get to that. So, I mean, Dave, if you check the party loot, I've put in the values there that I know.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I'm going to have to go back through the...
I could be wrong.
Level 3 mine. I'll do it during the week. I'll look through the level 3 mine thing, and I'll look through whatever. Anyway, it doesn't really matter now. You're not about to buy, you know, a fucking 10,000 gold pieces worth of something, so...
Let's be honest.
What would you guys like to do as time marches on?
If we're not about to go off and do something, Scales is going to go buy some donuts. Like, that's literally what Scales is going to go do.
Okay.
Mr. Rothbottom isn't here anymore, right? What's his name?
Oh, the teacher, Mr. Kringlebottom. Yeah, he was just there, and you know, and once he stopped Kronk throwing the kids up in the air, he kind of wandered off. He's probably back in the schoolhouse. You want to go talk to him?
I want to just know if there's I mean, he was close, so I thought it would be convenient. I want to know if there's been any developments with the...
I mean, you can stop him before he goes. I think I'll just expedite this.
I think I'll just rather go to the girl who got the visits from the witch.
Maybe talk to the parents more so than the girl.
She's not currently out walking around the streets at the moment.
I'm more actually interested in talking to the parents than the girl.
We're in the blacksmith.
Okay, so then you're gonna have to head to the blacksmith.
We need to sell off some armor and shit as well, so it works out perfectly.
I know there's one member of your party that is not welcome in the blacksmith right now.
I'll just stay back.
Okay, cool. Let's move you all over to the blacksmith.
Reynold, think of Panera's direction and be like, if Arthur comes back, take his loot off.
One second. I'm going to move the thing over here to the blacksmith. Here we go. Now. All y'all should be just moved down here a little bit. I don't know what the fuck they're doing there. Let's delete them. Here we go. Varelli is there. It's Autumn there, and Varelli is there.
She's in the forge?
Okay, cool. So, you guys... All right, so you hear the ting, 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 ting. And as you open the door again, this heat just rolls over your shoulders. And what you can see...
What is their general vibe?
Working but distracted.
Okay.
Who walks in first?
Robert, because he was leading the way.
Okay, Robert. Did you get her? Did you get her? Have you killed the witch? Have you killed the witch? She runs right up to you and just puts her hands on your cheeks. Have you killed her? Our daughter hasn't woken up in 5 days.
Oh fuck!
Please tell me you've killed her.
That's exactly why we came here. We wanted
to tell me you've killed her. You're on top of this, aren't you? You're on top of this.
Yeah, we haven't killed her yet, but that is priority numero uno.
What the fuck are you coming here for?
We wanted to hear what. If there's been any developments, and
it's been on developments, she's catatonic these 5 days.
That is a development, yes.
It's a non development.
We didn't know of this.
You may as well
know she was catatonic.
Where have you been?
We got jumped by bandits. It's been a long few days.
It took you 5 days to kill them.
There was a lot of bandits.
A lot of bandits.
We have to go.
5,000 of them. Our daughter's lying there.
Trust me, we're...
You have to lift her up and change the sheets every 2 hours on account of the sweat. She's pissing sweat. I swear to God, it's a wonder she's still alive.
I look over to Lamont.
What am I paying you help? For?
Is there anything you can do for her?
Who are you looking at?
Lamont.
I can try, but I don't think there's anything...
Probably a curse at this stage.
There's probably nothing I could do for it. Yeah, we'll need to deal with this witch.
It's getting dark at the moment. You would have entered town to say at like 4:30 in the evening. It's getting dark.
But I'll step up to her and
the forge casts an eerie light across the room. The anvils here just seem to cast us these long shadows.
With the scale shadow in the middle of it.
Exactly. With this, you know, it looks like this like demonic shadow with horns and a sickle and stuff like that.
So I'll step up to her and tell her that we tried to track the witch through the woods. We ran into some trouble. We are going to try again. But are things that we need.
Please don't say tell her you want to sell shit right now.
No. No, I'm not going to tell her we want to sell shit right now. This is more important. There were things that we needed to get done before we could do that. We are ready now to go do this.
Aren't you? My daughter has been pissing sweat lying in her own bed for 5 days. screaming about the carved witch. Screaming.
We're stronger than we were the first time we went in.
Blood coming off her lips because she's howling with terror all night long. And you went off on a few days, John, to take care of some bandits. Why should I pay you? What I'm paying you?
Scales is going to step up from where he went immediately to sit by the fire and then move forward, or the forge, and move forward and go like, we're going to go get the witch now.
And as you say that, the forge goes.
Extinguished?
And just the flames begin to dim. And you've all taken off your overcoats and your vestments, you know, the thing, your cloaks and things, because of the heat here. And you look to them on the ground as the temperature begins to plummet.
Can I reach out and try using my magic it's not working?
Wait till I finish. As the temperature begins to plummet, Valera looks around and you see her breath in her hands. Autumn, her breath is visible there in front of her. And in your head you hear, come take care of me, is it? I've been here longer than this town, longer than the mountains, longer than... And Scales, you hear this. Only you hear this. Longer than the Dragonborn. That's where we'll leave it for tonight.
Damn it, I was about to say all good things come to an end.
I was going to say, screw you, bitch.
That can be the first thing we do in the morning. That can be the first thing we do next session. Thanks, everyone, for joining us.
Thanks.
Thank you, guys, for being awesome players. Yeah. And we will see you guys in 2 weeks' time. Don't forget, we have our game on Sunday with Mark, who is running a bunch of level 20 characters against a Tarrasque, which will be a fucking carnage. And then on Tuesday, we have Jean's game, Fellowship of the Fallen. And then the following Friday, we have Richard's game, which is a Humblewood game. So there's the first week in advance for you guys. Thanks so much to everyone for tuning in. And we will see what fresh shit will hit the fan in 2 weeks' time.